and Bailey's Fine Jewelry.
It's the first day of the first grade, and she found a new best friend. It's a laid-back Sunday afternoon you wish would never end.
The homemade taste of Bluebell and good friends gathered round. The good old days are being made right now.
St. Louis brought the world gooey butter cake. Now Bluebell brings us gooey butter cake ice cream. A cake batter ice cream with a luscious cream cheese swirl and gooey butter cake pieces. Mmm, it's the gateway to the best in pints and half gallons.
The good old days are being made right now.
The good old days are being made right now.
Look for Bluebell ice cream at your neighborhood Food Lion.
The best thing about pollen? It's temporary. Just like the Autobell Car Wash Pollen Pass. Enjoy 3 months of unlimited car washes. Get your pass today and save at any Autobell. And when the pollen ends, so does your plan.
People can tell when you Autobell.
Direct Auto Insurance is for uncompromisers. The people who refuse to make trade-offs in life. Like Kelly, when her old car insurance got so expensive that she couldn't afford to drive anymore, do you think she started carrying her groceries for miles? No. But she did find Direct Auto's savings that allowed her to drive instead of compromise. With savings of up to 25%, you too can stop compromising and keep driving. Get a quote today at directauto.com. Savings based on applied discounts and will vary. Terms apply. How you buy can affect price. National General Group, Winston-Salem.
Sick of being upsold at gyms?
My guy, you're currently a base member. For $90 more, I can upgrade you to our Shred membership. For $130 more, you'll be a Swole member. And for just $300 more, you'll reach Sweat Platinum.
At Planet Fitness, you'll get energy without the upsell. Never pushy, always free fitness training and equipment for every workout. It's fitness that fits your budget. Join Planet Fitness for just $1 down and $10 a month. Cancel anytime. Deal ends Friday, April 12th. See Home Club for details.
Imagine waking up this time next week and being 100% debt-free. No credit cards, no car loan, no personal loan. Hey, it's Dennis Cox. Loan Pronto's Equity Express line of credit can make it happen. Homeowners are turning their home equity into cash almost instantly. With Loan Pronto's AI-based system, you can get approval in about 10 minutes. With almost no documentation, no appraisal, and no hassle, you can get hundreds of thousands of dollars out of your home. Use that money to pay off all your other loans. The average homeowner saves over $850 a month doing this. Listen, your home value is way up. You can use that to wipe out all those credit cards, get some money for a home improvement. Literally hundreds of thousands are at your fingertips, and approval is just minutes away. Call 919-381-1760, 919-381-1760, loanpronto.com, 919-381-1760, NMLS 1661781, subject to lender approval, equal housing lender.
This hour on the Triangle Sports Leader is brought to you by the Ritchie Law Firm Injury Lawyers.
You can feel the madness.
Go to gotbryan.com. That's gotbryan.com.
WCMC-FM HD1 Holly Springs.
People are talking about Kevin Keats being fired, no longer being a part of the program, to now every Wolfpack member saying, that's our guy, you know, moving forward. Also, we were listening to Scott Drew-Seth talk earlier about injuries. Michael O'Connell only played 13 minutes in this ballgame, really, right? Tough. And we talk about not having your floor general on the floor, and it wasn't by any, like, he literally just tripped and had an issue with his hamstring. He were on the floor, it might have been a different, I still think we would have Purdue favor, but these are the little small things that sometimes happen which can deter you from winning
a
game.
He was playing 35 minutes a game before that.
Tough.
It is the Adam Gold Show. Where am I? What time is it?
You're back on this side of the country.
Woo! Hi, everyone. Hi, Victoria.
Hi. Good to see you in real life.
Yeah. Oh, my God. What? How does this work?
Are you awake?
Yeah. I mean, sure.
That's okay.
As awake as I'm going to be. Awake as modern medicine will keep me right now.
It's going to be a weird day anyway because the moon's going to come out.
Look, we have the news on in the studio. Triangle residents preparing for the solar eclipse that's coming up after we're done.
Yes.
So they, you don't don't have to worry about it now.
I'm glad that they waited till after the show so we could all see it.
3:07-ish here?
Yes. I have my glasses ready and everything.
Well, apparently from the news reports that we've seen, if you look through, like if you like put a couple of holes in the bottom of a cereal box.
Yeah, Kellogg specific.
That will also protect your eyes like special sunglasses will.
Yes.
It seems odd to me, but
Special K.
Hey, I'm all about, and I think you can indirectly look at it. It's sort of like Medusa.
Ah, yes.
If you look directly at it, you turn to stone.
Don't stare too long.
So, but if you use like a reflection.
Yeah, maybe just through your fingers. No, I wouldn't advise that.
Or just like, you know, the back of your phone.
Yes.
I don't know. Or your phone. Your phone could actually be be a mirror, if you will. So, yeah, it's coming up today. I'm looking forward to it being dark at 3:07.
Yeah, to really confuse your system.
For less, I don't know how long
even
it's
more.
Be. So that'll happen, and we're here for it. The last time, I'm trying to it was like 7 years ago.
It was.
It was a bigger one there, wasn't it?
I was still living in Greensboro. It was a long time ago.
Were you okay? No, Trey Wingo was actually here that day.
Wow.
Because they had just started an ESPN morning show, and he was part of it and made did a station visit. As, you know, Jay Williams and Keyshawn Johnson did.
Right.
A few years back.
Mm-hmm.
This is typical. And Trey Wingo was here, and we had pictures of him going outside and just staring up into the sky.
Like everyone else.
Yeah, wearing sunglasses, the whole thing. So that's good. The Masters starts this week. My curiosity, did the solar eclipse get permission from Augusta National?
That's a good question.
Honestly, everybody needs permission from Augusta National to do anything, especially if it impacts the Masters. Now, granted, it's today. Masters doesn't start till Thursday, which probably means that the solar eclipse had to be moved up.
Right.
So to make sure
avoid any
that it
conflict.
Would avoid the Masters.
Mm-hmm.
Imagine if the Masters just went dark for like how long are we going to be dark?
How long am I going to need a flashlight? I think it's just a few minutes. It's not a long time.
All right, good.
So
all
right. Yeah.
So that
right.
We'll talk about total darkness for 2 minutes or however long it is. So let's see. We have the playoffs are starting soon in hockey. The playoffs are starting soon in the NBA. Baseball is here. The basketball season is almost over. One more college basketball game. It will be tonight.
Mm-hmm.
If you are listening locally, you can listen to it right here on 99.9 The Fan. And I am sure that many stations along this vast network will be carrying the game. Purdue and Connecticut. And for all intents and purposes, these were the two best teams all year. That rarely happens in college basketball, where you have the two best teams all year meeting, but I think that's what you've got tonight.
Mm-hmm.
But that doesn't mean we can't talk about how NC State coulda.
Maybe shoulda, but
could,
yes,
I don't
they
coulda. See, I wouldn't go shoulda. Coulda. Definitely coulda.
They coulda kept up a little better.
Coulda won that game. And that's where we're going to start. All right, let's start here. First of all, let's celebrate the run, Kevin Keats. The run to the Final Four, NC State's first in 41 years, which didn't look like it was even possible a month ago.
The way this story was written was unbelievable because we've had, in order to win any championships, you got to have highs and lows. We started the season with great highs. In the middle, there were some lows. But equally some highs then, and then at the end, regular season, there were lows. But look what this team was able to accomplish. I sit back and I just don't know how you can win 9 elimination games. All of those 9 games, we only had one of them that was not a double digit when we got in the NCAA tournament. There wasn't a double digit win. These guys always believed, they trusted.
Yeah, look, there's a fine line in sports that, especially when the best teams are the best teams. But once you get below the handful of teams that are clearly better than everybody else, then it really just becomes who plays better. It really does. Who plays better? Now, we don't have, we're not using series here. In a series, in a best of seven, it is rare that the better team doesn't win. Rare. That's what those things do. Well, I shouldn't say, in hockey it happens, right? Because goaltending and weird bounces of a puck, and in a sport where typically in the playoffs, three goals wins you a game, it's very easy to tip the scales one way or the other with a couple of lucky bounces. But in basketball, when there are 100 possessions both ways, yeah, in a seven-game series, better team's going to win. But in a one-game situation, anything can happen. No joke. Anything can. One thing Kevin Keats would like coming out of this is maybe a little bit more of the country remembering who NC State is.
I hope people understand that we have a heck of a basketball program, and we play a unique style, and we've got a great culture. You know, what's not talked about enough is, you know, we've had five teams in the last couple of years get in the tournament. We're one that's been 2 years in a row. Like, it's almost forgotten because we didn't make a run last year, but this is back-to-back NCAA tournaments where our league is so good and we're not getting the respect that we deserve. So in 2 years where we've got five, we've been one of the five a couple years.
Yes, that is true. Miami to the Final Four last year, NC State to the Final Four this year, Duke and Carolina the previous year. Like, nobody's surprised when Duke and Carolina make a Final Four, right? Nobody's shocked at that. But then you see other schools coming from the ACC making Final Four runs. And Kevin Keats is right. That doesn't mean that more ACC teams should have gotten in. But what it does, what I've never understood is why year in and year out, a certain conference performs well in the NCAA tournament. And then we just assume that something is going to be different this year, the following year. Now, I get what the metrics say. But the metrics is just math. It's just math. And that is not, math is not sports. There's a whole lot of different ways to measure sports that you can't do with math. But I totally understand why the committee and the people who do these things are beholden to the math, because that's what the committee tells them. So if they're looking at math, well, I guess we need to look at math too. And it's just too hard. You have so many teams. It's just too hard. You can't see all the games. I've said this a lot of times. I used to be an AP voter in football. 2 years in a row, I voted in the top 25 for the Associated Press college football poll. And I thought that was too many teams to watch.
It's a lot.
Right? And you're really not watching all 130-something. You're watching about 50, if that. But that was too many.
Mm-hmm.
And there's 360 Division I basketball programs. And again, even if we eliminated, two-thirds of them, you're still talking about watching over 100 teams play. Get out of here. There's no way you've seen that team play. No way. We're just guessing. And it makes it more difficult. Therefore, we have this math. We have all this math that we rely on. And math is not really good for determining things like who's good and who's not in sports. All right, I want to go to DJ Burns. Who, earlier in the season, and people have asked me, do you still feel the same way about DJ Burns? Remember, this goes back to probably January. And I thought, man, DJ Burns isn't nearly the good player that he was a year ago. Now that, they rely on him, like last year, he was almost a bonus.
Yeah.
This year, when they relied on him, like, he wasn't as good. He didn't look like he was the same player. He wasn't performing the same way. I thought he was a net negative at one point during the season. I was not afraid to say it because this is not a character assassination. He's an awesome dude. But in terms of a player, he was not helping them win. But he got it right. He became a great player as they got into the postseason. And he had a blast during the run.
Man, just to be a part of this has been everything I could have asked for, man. Didn't go the way we wanted to go out, but, man, this has been an experience like no other. It's something, you know, that I've wanted my whole life. And to be able to do it with the group of people that we have is just amazing, man. And the city, we're just glad we could bring the culture back to Raleigh and bring it back for state fans, man. They've been waiting for a long time, and I hope we give them something to, you know, build off of next year.
It was, we could just use the term magical. That's fine because it was so unexpected. In retrospect, I keep having to put a caveat on it. This team really did have good enough pieces to be an NCAA tournament team. And then as long as you are one of those, basically anything can happen. We haven't at all mentioned yet, and I want to spend at least a couple of minutes talking about the game. Because the game is not secondary to the run. The game, I mean, NC State had every chance in the world to beat Purdue on Saturday night. If you watched the game, and I trust most of you did, while Purdue looked like they were going to blow NC State off the court in the first half, it got to halftime just a six-point game. At one point, I believe it was 32-29 before the Boilermakers hit a three to make it 35-29 at the half. And State had kind of weathered that storm after they were down, I think, by 11 or even 12 in the first half. Zach Edey was too good, and when he was not being too good, Purdue was knocking down threes or getting offensive rebounds. Lost in all of it, Purdue is one of, if not the best, offensive rebounding team in the country, and they were destroying NC State on the glass.
Yeah.
And so at one point, there was like 10 second chance points out of Purdue's 12 points. That's what was happening early in the game. And State did a better job as the game wore on of mitigating that. And what they also did a better job of was guarding Edey.
Yeah, they did do good with that.
Zach Edey finished with 20 points. Mm-hmm. He had 14, I believe, at halftime.
Right.
So you're telling me that Zach Edey only had 6 points in the second half. I think State did a very good job.
That's impressive.
What they did was they guarded the perimeter a little bit better. They also, by pushing Edey out a little bit more, which happens when you guard the perimeter better and you push the perimeter out, Edey has to come out a little bit further to get the ball, which means if he wants to get to where he needs to get to, he's got to put the ball on the floor. And as soon as he did that, NC State swarmed the ball. They turned him over a bunch, whether it was stealing the ball from him or forcing a bad pass. They did that a bunch, and they were still in that game. It looked like Purdue was begging NC State to win. State could not shoot.
They could not get the ball in the hoop.
So I don't know what the numbers at the end of the second half were. They were not great, but they were 5 for their first 20. And that's the game.
Yeah.
That's the game. And eventually, Purdue, who shot exactly the same percentage from three-point range, 40%, as they did from two-point range, State held them to basically 30% shooting from two in the second half.
Mm-hmm.
But Purdue made a bunch of threes, which is their game.
Mm-hmm.
If Zach Edey isn't scoring, they're kicking it out to three-point shooters.
And State couldn't make anything.
State just could not shoot. And they missed a bunch of shots that I'm not going to say they normally make, because they're not a great shooting team, but they missed a bunch of makeable shots.
Yeah, the Diarra almost dunk.
Some layups.
Easy ones that you're like, any other day it would have gone in.
Right, but again, I get back to this. I get back to when Zach Edey's around the rim and he's a really good shot blocker, right?
Mm-hmm.
He's 7'12" or whatever he is. So when he's there, you have to account for that.
Mm-hmm.
And not only does he block shots, he changes shots. And what do I always say about defense? Good defense is cumulative. It has a cumulative effect. So when you have an opportunity close to the basket, you rush because you know it's coming.
Yeah.
So were they easy shots? Sure. To us, in retrospect, and maybe should have made more, but they're not as easy as we pretend them to be simply because the threat of Zach Edey.
Yeah, he's in their head. He's a threat.
If you've ever watched Victor Wembanyama play for the Spurs, if he is inside the three-point line, he can block your shot at the rim, it seems.
Mm-hmm.
It's like he's Stretch Armstrong.
Right.
Not only is he 7'4", but he can just reach out and touch the rim from the three-point line, it seems.
Yes, no problem.
All of that matters. So you rush, and it makes the shots a little bit more difficult. I do want to get to real quick, because we're going to talk about it more later on. And we're going to talk more about NC State in just a few minutes with Brian Geisinger. Last night, was it last? Yes, yesterday afternoon. Wasn't even last night, sorry. Yesterday afternoon, South Carolina won the national championship in women's college basketball. They are now 38-0. That's the way they finished the season, 38-0. It's, I believe, it's the fifth program ever to go undefeated in women's basketball to win a title. Connecticut's done it 6 times.
Yeah, it's tough to do. They did it.
Yeah, well, it's easy for Connecticut to do, apparently.
Yeah.
And South Carolina has done it now. And that is an incredible team. And if when you watch them, you go, my gosh, they have so many good players. Like, it's almost to the point where none of them stand out to you. Like, she's awesome. No wonder they're 38-0, right? Dawn Staley is the head coach, and she talked about carrying the weight of being perfect all year.
You know, it's a heavy load to be undefeated, to, you know, finish the job. And you get emotional because you just want that for them, and you're happy that you're able to, you know, because only one team wins a national championship.
She is 100%. That is a fact. All right. After the game, on the court, this was very cool. Because even though South Carolina is the best team in college basketball this year, the season has been about Caitlin Clark at Iowa. And it would be easy to carry the chip on your shoulder and say, you know, we've been focusing on a lot of the other things, which is fine, when these incredible women deserve your attention and and all of their flowers. But she took time out to praise Caitlin Clark.
I really would just like to say, I have to congratulate Iowa on an incredible season. Awesome, awesome. And I want to personally thank Caitlin Clark for lifting up our sport. She carried a heavy load for our sport, and it just is not going to stop here on the collegiate tour. But when she is the number one pick in the WNBA draft, she's gonna lift that league up as well. So Caitlin Clark, if you're out there, you are one of the GOATs of our games, and we appreciate you.
That's awesome.
It was tremendous. And Dawn Staley had said she was a great player too, by the way, at the University of Virginia. Never won a championship, but a great player. And she was one of those people talking about, yeah, to be the GOAT, you have to win a title. Breanna Stewart, who won 4 at UConn, that's right, 4, said you have to win a championship to be the greatest of all time. And I'm not going to get into the silly debates about that because honestly, I can see where you're right about that. It's hard to be the greatest ever.
It is. Everyone would do it if they could.
Right. It's hard to be the greatest ever without winning a championship.
Right.
So I'm not saying it's impossible because it's not impossible. And maybe Caitlin Clark is that. But I get where you're coming from when you say you can't be without it. I'm not in any way debating that. But what we can't debate is what Caitlin Clark meant to women's basketball this year. And I'll bring Tiger Woods into this equation. I'm not comparing her to Tiger Woods, but what Tiger Woods did for everybody coming to watch golf was you obviously wanted to watch Tiger. But by the same token, you also saw people that Tiger was competing against. And it raised the level of awareness in how good some of these athletes are, were. So my guess is that people who watched Caitlin Clark this year came away from those games going, holy cow, she's amazing. Not just Caitlin Clark, right? Caitlin Clark was amazing. But every time you watched Iowa play, if there was somebody else on the court that did amazing things, you went, wow, this is a much better game than I thought. And I thought the entirety of the NCAA tournament as I watched, that was just high-level basketball. And if you put a good product on the field or on the court or on the ice, people are going to watch it. And that's what the women's tournament was. It's a quality product. You found, like, oh my God, Juju Watkins? Give me some of her. I want to watch her ball again. So, she did. She elevated the sport. We'll see if it happens in the WNBA. No idea if it will or won't. All right, when we come back, Brian Geisinger is going to tell us what NC State did well that kept them in the game and what they didn't do that prevented them from winning it. Next.
Going beyond the box scores, Adam Gold on the North Carolina Sports Network.
Listen to 99.9 The Fan every afternoon during the drive for your chance to see the storm surge in person. It's our 10K playoff payout. Try your luck at playoff tickets by discovering the golden puck. And like last year, take your ultimate shot at $10,000.
Let's go!
Listen for the 10K playoff payout, driven by your Carolina Ford dealer. For great offers on a new Ford truck or SUV, see your Carolina Ford dealer today.
Adam Gold here from my friend Gordon Miller, Miller Lending, Kildare Farm Road in Cary, with this reminder. You could spend thousands of dollars in closing costs just to spend $50 less per month on your mortgage payment, but really that would be a sign that you have too much money, that you don't mind lighting $5,000 on fire. Give or take, that's what closing costs are. $5,000, give or take, depending on the size of your home loan. So if you're willing to do that, then clearly you have too much money. So just pay cash for the house and be done with it. Miller Lending found a better way back in 1987 when Gordon invented the no closing cost mortgage, which allows you to keep thousands of dollars in closing cost money in your pocket, in your account, do what you want with it, it's your money, and then refinance free of charge when the rates come down. Do you really think the rates aren't going to move for the next 5 years? Aha, they're going to. Frankly, they'll drop a lot this year because it's an election year. Take advantage of it. Don't ever pay closing costs. MillerLending.com, great website, will help you out. Miller Lending. An equal housing lender. NMLS ID 250-2146.
To tell you that Keno picks 20 winning numbers, we wrote a winning number of our own.
Hit it, boys. You pick up to 10. Keno picks 20. It's easy to play for a whole lot of money.
Winning numbers are everywhere with Keno from the North Carolina Education Lottery. Must be 18 to play. Approximate overall odds to win a prize range from 1 in 3.86 to 16.63. Problem gambling helpline 877-718-5543.
It's truck month at your local Ram dealer. And now's the time to get great deals on our award-winning lineup of trucks. At Ram, all we do is trucks. Maybe that's why Ram is the most awarded light-duty and heavy-duty truck brand over the last 5 years. Ram trucks feature innovative technology and uncompromised power and dependability that give you the power to strengthen your truck game. Go to Ram.com for great deals and hurry in for the best selection of trucks during Ram Truck Month. Based on total full-size pickup awards 2019 to 2023 CYTD, based on standard and available features offered.
Having pain like that and not knowing how you caused it and for how long it's lasting, it's debilitating.
QC Kinetics patient Diane Richardson hated not being able to live her life to the fullest due to joint pain. But then she called QC Kinetics, where regenerative treatments helped her pain go away.
The result was phenomenal.
QC Kinetics is the nation's leader in using natural biologics to restore and repair damaged joint tissue.
This was a great alternative for me as opposed to going in and possibly having surgery or something else. There was no downtime, and that's what I love. My life is too busy for me to be sidelined.
If you're tired of constant pain from arthritis or injury, don't think the old treatments are the only treatments. Discover regenerative medicine at QC Kinetics.
Just to feel good and know that I'm out of pain is the best thing ever. I'm able to do everything that I want to do.
Call QC Kinetics now for your free consultation.
Call QC Kinetics, 919-400-5473. That's 919-400-5473. In Cary, Clayton, Raleigh, and Wake Forest, 919-400-5473.
Hey everyone, it's Ted from Consumer Cellular, the guy in the orange sweater, and this is your wake-up call. If you're paying too much for wireless service, you don't have to keep having that nightmare. Consumer Cellular has the same fast, reliable coverage as the leading carriers for less. And for a limited time, new customers receive their second month free when they sign up and use promo code MONTHFREE by May 31st. So why keep spending more than you have to? Seriously, wake up and call 1-888-FREEDOM or visit ConsumerCellular.com.
Taxes, fees, and other third-party charges will apply. See website for additional details.
This is Adam Gold.
There are people out there that just, you must draft a quarterback.
Yeah, don't want a quarterback?
Exactly. What is wrong with you? Oh, you don't want apple pie?
Right.
Come on.
A la mode? No. Well, maybe I like brownies, okay?
I don't want it there.
The temptation.
Yeah, I don't need it. Because I can convince myself, apple's healthy.
Right.
The Adam Gold Show.
Oh, the best of Bonnie Tyler, right? This is it.
Of course, you have to play her today.
Is this the only song?
No, I have a whole playlist.
No, is this the only Bonnie Tyler song?
it should be.
I mean, I don't know that there's another Bonnie Tyler song.
Yeah.
We have a solar eclipse today just after 3 o'clock. Looking forward to all of it. It might have taken a solar eclipse to stop Zach Edey. He is a walking solar eclipse. I think he could block out the sun. Brian Geisinger is our Mr. Basketball. He joins us on the Adam Gold Show. Don't you think State did a good job on Edey, certainly in the second half?
Yeah, I thought they did. I mean, he's obviously a lot to deal with, and it generally requires more than just one guy. It's not just push button, get result. You need an entire team to do it. It requires multiple guys and both maybe to, stop him before the shot or to force a turnover and then on the offensive glass and then rotating around if you're going to double team and he's going to pass out and all of a sudden you're in rotation. It's a real challenge. In a lot of ways, he is sort of the archetypal, difficult to stop college center, right? Just the size, the offensive rebounding. It's crazy this guy didn't end up at UNC or something. He just seems so built for one of those brute offenses. And Purdue has designed it really well around him with all their shooting and spacing. But I thought State's game plan, I thought their game plan was good. I love some of the dig downs and the double teams that they had on Edey. I thought those were well-timed, well-executed. I loved them putting pressure on Braden Smith, who had a bad game. That to me was sort of low. If you scouted enough Purdue this year, it was sort of an obvious starting place. It was can we try to keep the ball out of Edey's hands by just getting this guy to cough it up? And during the broadcast, they kept saying Braden Smith usually doesn't make these kinds of turnovers. He's kind of a high turnover player, honestly. And I just like that State put guys like Jayden Taylor on him with athleticism and length to bother him. So I thought State's game plan was pretty good. They were a little, deck was stacked against them, and then, you lose O'Connell a couple minutes into the game, and it's just maybe wasn't going to be in the cards that night because they needed a lot of stuff to kind of cut in their favor to really, give themselves, the equity to sort of, pull off an upset potentially.
We'll get back to Michael O'Connell here in a second, but I want to go even a little bit further on how they defended, because as you're watching Zach Edey, if he catches the ball, where he doesn't have to put the ball on the floor, if he could just turn and shoot, you're done. You can't stop it. DJ Burns, for all of his size, looked like Zach Edey's little brother. I mean, he's probably, 6, maybe 7 inches shorter than Zach Edey, probably? So Edey just shoots over him. He didn't... If he catches the ball and he's close enough to the block, it's done. You can't stop it. He has to miss. And he will miss occasionally. But I thought what State really did in the second half was they extended their defense to the perimeter a little bit better, mm-hmm. which brought Edie away further away from the basket to catch the entry pass, which meant that he had to put the ball on the floor a little bit more. Mm-hmm. And once that happened, swarms came.
Yeah.
And they kept knocking the ball away. So every time he put the ball on the deck, I'm not sure they didn't either get a deflection, force a turnover. It disrupted Purdue in the second half. I thought they defended great.
Yeah, and you got to remember, like, on the flip side, too, it means if you do that, it's less room, there's less space you have to then cover. Obviously, it pushes him further away, which means, I mean, he's got a good hook shot, but it means,
yeah.
you know, that's not as good as a dunk or a layup. It means it's more likely he's got to put the ball on the floor, which he basically never does. Like, he almost never dribbles, you know. Like, his post-ups, as we've discussed, Gold, they don't look like the DJ Burns post-up, right? They're like,
no.
you know, high-low, seal in the lane, get a layup. You know, it's not, you know, back down from 18 feet, and, you know, spray out the shooters and the double team comes usually. But also it means that if he's catching the ball further out and you're coming with the double teams and the guards, you're digging down, that type of stuff, it's less room for them to have to then get back out to the three-point arc when he passes out, right? Like, again, State's game plan was good. It was well executed. Like, it just sort of like the offense couldn't quite get out of the mud. They probably needed, like, one or two more bodies. And then, I mean, obviously, like, Edie makes it tough on the flip side with how they're able to, like, deploy him defensively and sort of, like, protect him and then use him to protect the basket. And that way he can also sort of, like, use energy for the glass and
right.
for offense. So, like, again, Matt Painter's really built this, like, machine around him. And it's a lot to deal with. But, like, I thought State, I mean, the score didn't look great maybe at times, but, like, I didn't think they were, like, out of their depth. And, like, I just think, again, throughout this entire postseason run, State definitely had some magic on their side. State definitely had, like, great individual performances from basically everyone at certain times. I also thought, like, Kevin Keats and the staff were, like, dealing, too. Like, I thought they just had, like, stuff cooked up and ready to go for different types of opponents,
right.
different types of environments.
I loved everything about what they did. I really did. I was impressed. They just couldn't make shots. And maybe
yeah.
that comes back to Michael O'Connell, but they had a ton of shots. Seemed like DJ Horn was the only guy really making baskets for
yeah.
them throughout the game. Was it as simple as that? Because I didn't think Purdue's perimeter defense was anything special.
No, perimeter's defense is pretty – I mean, you don't think it's special to see Fletcher Lawyer flop 20 times throughout the game. Just a beautiful ode to Cormac Ryan. I thought that was
yeah.
like just a masterpiece by Fletcher Lawyer. Really, really good stuff. But no, I mean, I think Purdue's, like, they've got a lot of, like, good shooters on the perimeter room. And I like Lance Jones as sort of like the one guy that's got some, like, north-south
yep.
you know, zip offensively for them. And he hit some big shots for them, you know, from deep in this game too. But, like, they're pretty average athletically and size-wise, you know what I mean, in terms of, like, perimeter defenders. And it's really, they're sort of like the guys that are, like, in the three, you know, the small four power forwards for them, the Cameron Hyde, the Mason Gillis, that's when they've actually got some, like, size and athleticism that they can throw at you. But most of the ones and twos, like, it is what it is. I think State, I think, you know, the two best passers on State's roster are DJ Burns and Michael O'Connell. And that's not just because of the assist numbers, that's like, you know, those guys are 1 and 2 on assist rate for the team. If you watch State play, you know how important O'Connell's passes are in transition.
Right.
On the secondary break. We talked about this all season. And, like, he's a good passer, you know, in the half court for them too. And I do think they missed that. You know, okay, not great shooter. Who knows? Maybe he would have had a role in that night. You never know, and you
right.
never know, because he got tripped by the court monster out there, and it just, you know, unfortunately could only play 11 minutes, and he was compromised for most of those, which is, it's really unfortunate, because he had a great season and a great postseason, and it does sort of circle back. Well, I remember the first time I came on your show this season, back in November, we were talking about State, and my concern was the lack of, like, half-court creation, and
right.
how reliant they were going to be on to force a double team, which Purdue didn't really have to do. And then DJ Horn stepped up and became a big time player for them, but just they never quite had another like reliable shot maker in the guard room. Guys would perk up, you know, Morstell had some good games. Jane Taylor had some good games. Jane Taylor played well actually against Purdue. You know, Connell obviously hit some big shots. They just kind of needed, you know, Breland Pass stepped up and had some minutes for them in the Final Four, so like salute him. But, you know, they just didn't have the one other guy, you know, that could reliably like, you know, hit off the dribble, you know, get to the rim. I thought Horn did a really nice job cutting, moving without the ball in this postseason run for State too. So, you know, they were, you know, probably again, like just missing like a little bit more shot creation, you know, in the guard room.
All right, one more thing. Mo Diarra didn't have his best offensive game. He had opportunities.
Mm-hmm.
Thoughts on where he is in his development as a player?
Yeah, I mean, and look, I wrote about this and talked about this before the game. I didn't think they'd open with Zach Edey on DJ Burns. I thought they would do Trey Kaufman-Wren on Burns and then have Edey sink in the paint and then just, like, try to, like, challenge Diarra to make spot-up threes, which is something he can do, but, like, you'll probably live with that,
right?
You know? And that's tough because, like, yes, looks could make him. For me, it kind of felt like that was sort of, like, battlegrounds. I think I wrote about this to keep an eye on. Like, if Moody Yard hits like two or three threes, like, is that enough to swing it? Is that enough to get Purdue to change up the matchups? And then all of a sudden, if you can get Edey guarding Burns, and Burns can drag him away to the mid post, and then all of a sudden you can open up cutters going to the rim, like that kind of stuff. And it just never happened. As far as like development for Yard, like, the guy had an amazing season. And like, he was basically a superhero for them the last 3 weeks, and given you know, his observance of Ramadan and how he's being the sports science, you know, sports medicine team around State have been able to manage that just brilliantly. And just unbelievable credit to him for doing that. It was really courageous and commendable stuff from him. He was playoff season. If you were watching State in December, you knew this guy like was a beast defensively.
Yep.
And could really, you know, do stuff on the glass. So like, he's awesome already. If he could somehow become like a high, you know, 30s catch and shoot, high 30s%, you know, catch and shoot 3-point guy, and all of a sudden you can spot up, you can do more pick and pop stuff with him. Like, you can kind of do it already. It's one thing to be a regular season game, you know, on a Saturday afternoon in Conte Forum against Boston College. You know what I mean? It's another thing when all of a sudden you're going up against like the cold dark machinery of Purdue, who is going to game plan around you. You know what I mean? But he's a phenomenal player. Like, he's on his way. I mean, like, if he ends up in the NBA at some point or not, he's going to get a look. And if not, he's going to go to Europe and have a phenomenal professional career there, too. Like, he's a big-time player, and I love covering him this season.
Yeah, he is a super fun player to watch play, too. I hope he gets, like, enough NIL money to not be tempted to leave NC State.
But that's the thing, though. He's from France, so he can't get NIL money in America.
Oh, that's right.
I know, it's stupid. It's a very dumb, bad rule. But like,
that is a bad rule.
Some, I don't know, we need some...
Can he get French NIL money?
Yeah, he can. So we need someone to step up. If there's some...
a wine. We need a friend, like Moët Chandon, right?
Perfect.
Maybe they can do that.
Perfect. Yeah, exactly.
All right.
Some cheese, maybe. I don't know, whatever it takes, you know?
Camembert. I don't know. I'm just the Tour de France
it.
can hire him. Brian Geisinger.
He's an awesome cyclist. You know he would be.
I bet he's been on a bike before.
I bet so too.
Brian Geisinger, our Mr. Basketball. You know we're not done with you. I appreciate your time. I'll talk to you later.
Yeah, can I just say real quickly?
Sure.
Just a big salute to Kevin Keats and NC State. This run, I know it's been said countless times. It should be said countless more times. This was awesome to watch. This has been like one of the most fun things I've ever had as a like covering a team. And I really needed a boost the last couple of weeks. I mean, getting to watch this team play was a lot of fun. So it was felt, you know, my little office watching this team with the sound off.
Very
it
nice.
It was really a joy. And it gave me a charge, you know, kind of when I needed it. So I would just like to say salute to them. It will never be forgotten, at least in my head.
Well, that is well said. I'll talk to you very soon, my friend. I appreciate it.
Yeah. Take care, guys.
You got it. At @bgeis_bird, Brian Geisinger, our Mr. Basketball. I want to say one thing before we hit the break, and we have one timers on the other side. It has been obviously unexpected that NC State end up in a Final Four, especially as the season went on. If you've been doing this, what I do, long enough, I have been accused, by the way, of being a homer for NC State. I have been accused of being a homer for all the schools at one time or another, and I will wear that. But what I do is recognize a good story. And this team was a good story. It became a good story. But part of the reason why this team became such a good story is because of a fan base that had been essentially left by the side of the road by the sport for 30 years. Now, the fans didn't go away in 83, after 83. They were still there. They won the ACC tournament in 87. They got to an Elite Eight in 85 and 86. They were in the NCAA tournament as a six seed in 1991. I covered them. That was Les Robinson's first year. But basically, in the wake of the Valvano scandal, and I hesitate to even use scandal, but whatever, the program, for whatever reason, and I don't even care the reasons, the program had not returned on any regular basis to being really good for, it's been 30 years. So those people who have been diehard fans, you pass fandom down from generation to generation, hadn't experienced anything close to this in 30 years. So you can tell me that I'm a homer, but those people deserve something good.
Yeah.
And this was awesome. And so I don't really care if you think I've paid too much attention to them. I apologize. My response to you is win.
Yeah.
Win your game, Carolina. Yeah. You had the chance to end state season, and you didn't.
Exactly.
And then they went to your Final Four. So stow that crap.
Mm-hmm.
Those people deserved it.
Let them have it.
And look, I loved Carolina all year long. I don't think I've ever talked more glowingly about a team that wasn't necessarily like the 05 team and the 09 team.
Yeah.
Those teams were going to lay waste to the competition, and they did. Different level. This team was cut from a different cloth. It just didn't win the two games it needed to win.
Mm-hmm.
It didn't beat State on ACC tournament final Saturday night,
mm-hmm.
and they didn't beat Alabama in the Sweet 16. Had they won those two games, we might be having a completely different story. They could be playing tonight.
Absolutely.
But holy cow.
I know. They earned it.
I get the rivalry.
Sure.
You
want
to have fun with the rivalry? That's all good. But these people deserved something. There's a little bit of a human condition here.
Yeah.
That I will cape up for a Wolfpack fan for that. All right, quick break. One-timers on the other side. Next.
Serving it up hot and fresh every day. Adam Gold on the North Carolina Sports Network.
Trust ACT Construction Equipment and Bandit Wood Chippers and Stump Grinders to position your tree service for success. ACT Construction Equipment is your authorized dealer for sales, service, parts, and rentals for Bandit Wood Chippers and Stump Grinders. ACT Construction Equipment has been your authorized dealer for Bandit Equipment for over 10 years. Visit one of our six North and South Carolina locations or actce.com for more details on Bandit Wood Chippers and Stump Grinders. ACT Construction Equipment, always the right equipment for the job.
It's playoff time in the NBA and the NHL. Baseball's in full swing, and FanDuel is your place to bet on every game. Adam Gold here. And right now, new customers can get $200 in bonus bets guaranteed when you make your first $5 wager. because you know me. FanDuel.com promo code AGS to sign up. FanDuel.com promo code AGS to sign up. Then you can bet on anything. Slap shots, home runs, slam dunks, all on an app that is safe, secure, and easy to use. $200 in bonus bets await when you place your first $5 wager. Visit FanDuel.com promo code AGS to get started. FanDuel is America's number one sportsbook. Must be 21 and older and present in North Carolina. First online real money wager only. $10 deposit required. Bonuses issued as non-withdrawable bonus bets that expire 7 days after receipt. Restrictions apply. See full terms at FanDuel.com/sportsbook. Gambling problem? Call 877-718-5543 or visit morethanagame.nc.gov.
The Body Armor State Games are coming to Charlotte this June. Registration is open to athletes of all ages and skill levels. In 25 different sports. The Body Armor State Games features 13,000 athletes and 700 teams. Don't miss out on North Carolina's largest sports festival of the year. Visit BodyArmorStateGames.org today. The Body Armor State Games are proud to partner with Truist, Harris Teeter, and Blue Cross and Blue Shield of North Carolina.
Fair housing is more than just a celebration in April. For North Carolina's realtors, it's an everyday standard. For the 56,000 realtors across our state, we embrace and support fair housing to stamp out discrimination in all forms. As realtors, we believe fairness is worth fighting for, and we won't stop until the fight is won. Celebrating Fair Housing Month, North Carolina Realtors. We open doors to everyone. Paid for by North Carolina Realtors.
Healthcare.gov is here for you when life happens. If you lost your health coverage because of turning 26, going off Medicaid, leaving your job, or moving, you could be eligible to enroll in new coverage now. And if you need to update your coverage because of marriage or having a baby, you could also be eligible. But don't wait. There's a limited time to enroll. Check your eligibility at healthcare.gov today. Life happens. Get covered. Paid for by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services.
It's the first day of the first grade, and she found a new best friend. It's a laid-back Sunday afternoon you wish would never end.
The homemade taste of Bluebell and good friends gathered round. The good old days are being made right now.
St. Louis brought the world gooey butter cake. Now Bluebell brings us gooey butter cake ice cream, a cake batter ice cream with a luscious cream cheese swirl and gooey butter cake pieces. Mmm, it's the gateway to the best in pints and half gallons.
The good old days are being made right now.
The good old days are being made right now.
Look for Bluebell ice cream at your local grocer and pick up your favorite flavor today.
This is Adam Gold.
I would like to go to the supermarket with the Bears front office.
Exactly.
Right? Oh, no. Do I want like fruits and vegetables, or do I want this box of Devil Dogs? Devil Dogs, by the way, the greatest snack cake known to mankind. Unfortunately, you need a lot of milk. Otherwise, you're out of luck.
The Adam Gold Show.
Oh, very nice. Very nice. It's a total solar eclipse Monday.
Yes.
Which is interesting with Edie versus Klingon in the national championship game of men's basketball today.
Mm-hmm.
That's what we should do. We should refer to it as men's basketball and the women's tournament just as basketball.
Yeah.
That was a super fun game. Man, South Carolina's good.
Oh, yeah.
Holy cow. Every position on the floor hurts.
Oh, yeah.
Every single one. They were fabulous. Credit to Dawn Staley and company for winning.
I know. And they didn't get frazzled when Caitlin Clark and company were coming out hot.
10-0.
Oh, yeah.
And some of the shots that Clark was hitting was like, okay.
Stupid. Half-court shots almost.
She's 30 feet from the goal. This is good. I don't need to get closer.
Yep, nope, I'm fine right
here. And she doesn't. That's why you got to guard her, and that's why you got to watch. All right, it's time for one-timers. Questions and answers. I hope to have the right answers.
I know. Well, so speaking of Caitlin Clark, so with her being out of college basketball and now going into the WNBA, do you see her shining as bright with all these other big fishes as well?
Can she shoot?
We'll see.
Yeah. No, no, she can shoot.
I mean, she can shoot, but up against
not worried about
people.
It. The 3-point line. Yeah, no, she's going to be great. She was more than just a shooter. She was an offense creator for Iowa. She made other players around her better.
On the court, cheerleader.
She is going to be dynamite. So
I'm excited to see it.
What we don't know, and we'll actually talk to Darren Revelle about this later on. We don't know if she can do for women's professional basketball what she did for college basketball. That's what we don't know. And we won't know until we experience her in the WNBA. But she will have zero trouble transitioning to pro ball.
Yeah.
None.
She'll be fun to watch.
People who can shoot can shoot. Like, no joke, when the year Steph Curry was drafted, the first player taken in that draft, I believe, was Blake Griffin. James Harden was in that draft, too. And I said I would take Steph Curry one overall. And why? Because shooting never goes out of style.
It's important.
I had no idea that the three ball would be as prevalent as it was becoming. He has totally changed the game. And look, I'm not trying to say, I told you. Nah. The other players in that draft were great. James Harden is a Hall of Famer. Blake Griffin, were it not for injuries, probably would have been knocking down the door for a Hall of Fame. Steph Curry is one of the 5 to 8 best players to ever live. Why? Because he can shoot from anywhere.
Mm-hmm.
Caitlin Clark could have that kind of an impact in the WNBA.
Yeah, she's amazing. Yep. So, moving on to men's basketball, college basketball, NC State. So, to be in the mix again regarding either ACC tournament or NCAA tournament, do they need to repeat this next year in a timely fashion to wipe off that Cinderella label, or did they already do that, your opinion?
You got to follow it up. You can't be a one-hit wonder. Kevin Keats said this was the 3rd NCAA tournament appearance in his time at NC State. And 2 out of 7, I believe, wouldn't have been acceptable. 1 year there was no tournament. I get it. They've got to start stacking good seasons. But again, this team was good enough to put themselves in NCAA tournament position without needing to win the ACC tournament. So the trick will be, getting another roster that's worthy and having it play well all year, not just in 1 month. So,
yeah.
But they have to do that.
Yeah, they should. So, with all of this attention, do you anticipate seeing State's fan base grow even more with basketball and football for next year?
Football is not going to grow anymore. It's already massive. But basketball, they just want a reason to go. And that's it. So, is the building maybe... Yeah, like, you don't have to put 19,000 people in the building for a basketball game. You don't have to do that. But you can't have 10,000 in there either.
Yeah.
So you're going to have to get to 15,000 a game. Doesn't have to be a sellout, but you got to be better. Part of that is having a team that people can rely on being in every game, but winning most of your home games, if not all of them. So, yeah, they need a little bit more to be able to rely on. If they get that, I think the fans will show.
Yeah, and last but not least, so the battle of the top teams, UConn versus Purdue. How do you see this going tonight?
Connecticut's the best team, and I don't think it's all that close. But there is something interesting about Purdue and Zach Edey. We'll see.
Serving it up hot and fresh every day. Adam Gold on the North Carolina Sports Network.
Hey, it's Adam Gold, and you've heard me say this before. My entire goal in life is to make other people's lives easier, maybe even better. I tell this to you. I tell it to my wife all the time. And if you are a contact lens or glasses wearer, I'm going to help you out. Dr. Lori Travers and Travers LASIK, the only LASIK specialist in the Triangle, and the best way to make your life easier, did so for me about 12 years ago. 919-510-6830, TraversLASIK.com. I no longer wear contact lenses. I no longer have to get glasses, replacement lenses, solutions, all of that stuff that costs money and takes time. I no longer have to do it. And by the way, 0% financing for 24 months is available, and you can get $1,000 off. TraversLASIK.com. Do it now. 919-510-6830. 919-510-6830. See clearly, finally, without contacts and glasses. Travers LASIK. See what you've been missing.
Mitchell Heating and Cooling. We do the job right every time.
I'm Drake May, quarterback at UNC. Trust the team at Mitchell Heating and Cooling for your HVAC needs. Together we win. Call Mitchell Heating and Cooling today.
Contact us now at MitchellHVAC.com or 919-556-5069. Train. It's hard to stop a train.
Direct Auto Insurance is for uncompromisers, like Matt. When his old car insurance got so expensive, do you think he walked until his sneakers wore out? No, because he found savings with Direct Auto so he could drive instead of compromise. With savings of up to 25% on state minimum coverage, you too can stop compromising and keep driving. Get a free quote at directauto.com or a store near you. Savings vary, terms apply. National General Group, Winston-Salem.
The wait is over. DraftKings Sportsbook, an official sports betting partner of NASCAR, is now live in North Carolina. Now you can legally bet on all your favorite sports anytime, anywhere, right in North Carolina with DraftKings. For a limited time, new customers who sign up with promo code TIMD, T-I-M-D, no spaces, and bet $5, they'll receive $200 instantly in bonus bets. DraftKings has the best features, including same-game parlays, player props, and more, with fast and easy payouts right at your fingertips. Download the DraftKings Sportsbook app now using code TIMD and bet $5 to get $200 instantly in bonus bets only on DraftKings Sportsbook with code TIMD. The crown is yours. Gambling problem? Call 877-185-543 or visit morethanagame.nc.gov. 21 plus, North Carolina only. Bonus bets expire 168 hours after issuance. Deposit and eligibility restrictions apply. Terms at DraftKings.com/sportsbook/NC. NASCAR is not a sponsor of this promotion and used under license.
What is dedication?
People ask how your children learn how to ride a bike and you didn't. I just created an environment where they taught themselves, and all I had to do was be there.
That's dedication. Visit fatherhood.gov to hear more. Brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services and the Ad Council.
Savings. Now that's speaking the Lowe's language. And with my Lowe's rewards, your savings just keep coming. Save money with member-only offers and earn points when you shop. More points equal more rewards just for you. Because Lowe's knows you earned it, literally. Learn more about our new loyalty program at Lowe's.com/MyLowe's Rewards. Program subject to terms and conditions. Points are awarded on eligible purchases. See Lowe's.com/terms for full details. Subject to change.
This hour on the Triangle Sports Leader is brought to you by the Ritchie Law Firm Injury Lawyers.
You can feel the madness!
Go to GotBryan.com. That's GotBryan.com.
WCMC HD1 Holly Springs. Take us with you on radio, web, app, Alexa, and YouTube. 99.9 The Fan, the Triangle Sports Leader.
They lost 7 of the last 9 going into the ACC tournament. Then they won 5 games in 5 days. This is historic. That's what I mean, it's historic. It's not the 5 games in 5 days. It's who they beat. The all-time, last 10 years, the winningest team in the ACC is Virginia. Then they go and they beat Duke, and then they go and beat Carolina. That 5 games set up, we all said, wait a sec, well, you know, can't expect much from the NCAA tournament. And all they did in the next 2 weekends is show up and play. Kevin Keats, the agility to adjust was absolutely tremendous. What a great job Kevin Keats did, and what a great job his team did buying in when no one gave him a chance.
Seth Greenberg from ESPN on NC State's run to the Final Four. This is the Adam Gold Show. I'm Adam Gold, Victoria producing the program. There's a lot going on today. It is the start of Masters Week. In this hour, we're actually going to get a little Masters taste. Going to do a little bit today, a little bit tomorrow, a little bit Wednesday. Get ready for the first major of the season. We already have the first dumb story about the Masters. Might as well talk about it.
It's already producing.
Might as well talk about it. I'll give you a preview of what the dumb story is. The LIV just had a golf tournament this week in Miami. And they do their press conference before the tournament starts. And the moderator asks Bryson DeChambeau and Brooks Koepka. The moderator asks, so can a LIV golfer win the Masters? On stage, somebody who has won a U.S. Open recently and somebody who has five major championships, not a Masters, but five majors, what do you think the answer is going to be? Of course, the defending champion of the Masters is on LIV. The guy who won the Open Championship, not this past summer, the summer before, plays on LIV. Somebody with a Masters and a U.S. Open title to his credit in the last, 8 years, plays on LIV, the LIV circuit. Please. It's just, and I just wish people wouldn't take the bait.
Yeah.
It's not worth writing about. It's just a roll-your-eyes story. And every time a LIV golfer does well in a major championship, see, the LIV Tour deserves respect. Nobody has ever said that there weren't great players on it. Never has anybody said, you guys don't have enough good players. They got tons of good players. Tons of them. I mean, it's not, look, I'm not going to get into the reason why LIV isn't getting world golf rankings points. It's really a them problem, not a world golf ranking problem. Either way, we know how good the players are. So, duh. Anyway, we'll talk about the Masters because the Masters is cool, and we'll talk about it with Scott Mishaw a little bit later on. All right, we got a lot of things to do. Second take at the news of the day. We'll start with NC State. DJ Horn was really the only guy who was going to make shots. Not was going to, but did make shots in the loss to Purdue on Saturday night. And he had a great year. A great year for the Wolfpack. Led him in scoring. He was essentially at times carrying them. So, what did he think about everything that transpired?
It's been fun, every step of the way, every win that we've gotten. It's felt like a championship. To see all the joy and the happiness that it's brought, our university, our city and everything, how many people got behind us, not just from NC State, but the whole country. It just shows, when you come together and, stick together, what you can do as a team. And I'm just, grateful that I was a part of it all.
All right. He mentions how many people supported them. NC State's got tons of fans here, right? And as I was walking from our hotel to State Farm on Saturday afternoon, it was amazing to see the sea of red.
Yeah.
It was so cool.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you've got four different fan bases. So on one side, you've got Connecticut and Alabama. By the way, even the students weren't wearing Alabama basketball jerseys. They were wearing football jerseys, which, yes, of course, I get it. But you've got Connecticut and Alabama on one side, Purdue and NC State on the other. I would say that between Purdue and NC State, they probably covered about 70% of the fan base that was attending the game that wasn't neutral. It was all red and all black. UConn of the other 30%, UConn was probably 2/3 of that. And then Alabama was like, it ain't football, but right. It's our school, so yeah. Maybe we'll go.
Yeah, why not?
And that's fine. But I was super impressed. I gave State a little bit of an edge over Purdue in terms of the overall impact or the overall, you know, if you had to divide up the pie, a little bit more red than black during the national anthem. Look, I'm not a fan of the people shouting things in the anthem like in
hockey does it a lot.
Yeah, we do it at Hurricanes games, but I'm over complaining about it. But during the national anthem, Wolfpack.
A lot of red.
Oh, yeah. No, they shout.
That's what I mean. Yeah.
During the thing. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Just, it was very obvious that there was a ton of State fans.
Yeah.
At the game. So it was great to see it. I talked about it before. They deserve it. They absolutely deserve it. Let's talk about the other tenant in the building at PNC Arena, the Carolina Hurricanes. So last night, Andrei Svechnikov comes back. He missed a game on Friday for, I'll use the air quotes, illness. I'm not going to get into it. Even if he was a healthy scratch, which that's not the way Rod Brind'Amour operates as the head coach. Even if he was a healthy scratch, whatever. He played. He started the first shift, and the first shift was a goal for Andrei Svechnikov.
Yeah, it was.
It took 17 seconds.
Love it.
For Andre to get on the score sheet, and Rod talked about Andre and why it was needed.
I mean, I thought he was good. He's played well. You wanted to be that, what he did tonight, have a difference in the game in a positive manner. He certainly did.
All right, more of Rod on Andre.
Well, it's good for him. I think just whether he missed the game or not, I mean, just have an impact in the game like he did was good.
He was very good. He didn't take the bait throughout the game. He didn't go to the penalty box. Actually, Seth Jarvis did once.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right? Because he retaliated from a clean check,
yeah,
which he didn't need to do, regardless.
Feeling spicy.
Yeah. But Andre, just stay out of the box.
Yeah.
Stay out of the penalty box.
Please and thank you.
You will impact the game in a positive manner. All right. Now, the other big story happened last night. John Calipari is leaving Kentucky for Arkansas. It's actually not a terrible move. Paul Feinbaum from ESPN.
Greeny, amazingly, I think both fan bases are happy this morning. You say, well, how could that be? Cal is a legend. Well, he's a legend who had really played out at the University of Kentucky. Fans were tired of him. When he got knocked out by Oakland a couple of weeks ago, that was the second time in three seasons he lost in the first round. That is unforgivable. And I think he came, Greeny, within a whisker of getting fired. The only reason he stayed there, a $33 million buyout. Meanwhile, Arkansas has been a great program. We know about Nolan Richardson and that epic era, but Eric Musselman had taken them to two Elite Eights and 3-16s. And when he left the other day, people were going, where can this program go? They get John Calipari, who on one hand may be diminished, but when you give him a chance to restart, he might be a welcome to that fan base. But the University of Kentucky this morning has an opportunity now to upgrade the program after Calipari.
All right, here's the good part, right? It was obvious that Kentucky was done with Cal. It was obvious. He might be that type of a coach that legitimately has like a 10-year shelf life, which maybe is like most coaches. There's very few that do the Roy Williams, Mike Krzyzewski, Jim Boeheim thing. Heck, Rick Pitino is as successful a coach as just about anybody, and Rick couldn't do that. I mean, he was at Kentucky before he decided, yeah, you know what, maybe the Boston Celtics. Probably not a good idea, right? He actually left the Knicks to go to Kentucky. It'll be interesting to see if Kentucky gets an NBA coach to take over that program. Anyway, bottom line is, he was clearly done in Lexington, and this is his exit strategy. Arkansas is a good place. You can win at basketball there. They love the sport, and I know everything you read, they've got $5 million a year in NIL money to spend. Okay, that's fine. Whatever. Whatever you need. But Cal will do well at Arkansas, and Kentucky will now have to find the next right coach. They don't always get it right. They don't always. You got to get it right. We'll see if they do. All right, when we come back, we're actually going to talk to my friend Matthew Lawrence, who does sports radio in Kentucky, to find out how they are processing today, because I do believe that about, I think the reaction will be mixed. Half the people will be excited, and half the people will be like, how did you let Cal walk to Arkansas? Because he's staying in their league. Matthew Lawrence next.
Raleigh to Boone, Charlotte to Chapel Hill. Your Carolina is covered. Adam Gold on the North Carolina Sports Network.
Bring on the madness.
Unfortunately, the Pack's journey ends here in Phoenix tonight, and so does one of the most memorable seasons in recent NC State basketball history.
The inbound to Ross, and UConn can see history. One win away from a repeat national championship.
College basketball tournament action on 99.9 The Fan is powered by Wake Med, Roofworks, and Wilkinson Chevrolet Cadillac Buick GMC in Sanford.
Now that the Final Four is over for us, hi, this is Adam Gold. Although we do have an epic game tonight between two giant human beings, the NBA, the NHL, Major League Baseball, we got a lot going on. We got playoffs in one. We got regular season just really getting underway in the other. And FanDuel is your number one sports book in America. And right now, new customers can get $200 in bonus bets guaranteed when you make your first $5 wager. FanDuel.com, promo code Adam Gold to sign up. FanDuel.com, promo code Adam Gold. $200 in bonus bets guaranteed, win or lose. When you make your first $5 wager, FanDuel is America's number one sportsbook. Must be 21 and older and present in North Carolina. First online real money wager only, $10 deposit required. Bonuses issued as non-withdrawable bonus bets that expire 7 days after receipt. Restrictions apply. See full terms at FanDuel.com/sportsbook. Gambling problem? Call 877-718-5543 or visit morethanagame.nc.gov.
What are you doing?
I'm training for the new Ultimate Dash Scratch-Offs. I could get a chance to dash through a warehouse full of prizes.
That explains the shopping cart.
Plus, I could win up to $2 million in cash.
And that explains the tuxedo.
I'm chafing.
Feel the rush with new Ultimate Dash Scratch-Offs from the North Carolina Education Lottery. Must be 18 to play. Approximate overall odds of winning are 1 in 3.78. Problem gambling helpline, 877-718-5543.
The future of medicine is here at QC Kinetics. QC is the nation's leader in the most exciting revolution in pain management we've seen in decades, regenerative medicine. If you are tired of achy joints, if your joint pain is keeping you from doing what you love, you need to call QC Kinetics now. Surgery, steroids, drugs, these are no longer your best options. Regenerative medicine at QC Kinetics is transforming lives with innovative treatments that deliver lasting results. We're talking natural biologics, using your body's own power to repair and restore damaged tissue. QC Kinetics is under the leadership of National Medical Director Dr. Mitchell Sheencup. Dr. Sheencup is a pioneer in this field with 20 years of clinical work, tons of research, teaching, and publishing. He wants to get you relief with a needle, not a knife. Call QC Kinetics now to learn more about some exciting options. This is a revolutionary approach that can get you long-term relief with no downtime. 919-400-5470. With locations in Cary, Clayton, Raleigh, and Wake Forest. 919-400-5473.
It's truck month at your local Ram dealer, and now's the time to get great deals on our award-winning lineup of trucks. At Ram, all we do is trucks. Maybe that's why Ram is the most awarded light-duty and heavy-duty truck brand over the last 5 years. Ram trucks feature innovative technology and uncompromised power and dependability that give you the power to strengthen your truck game. Go to ram.com for great deals and hurry in for the best selection of trucks during Ram Truck Month. Based on total full-size pickup awards 2019 to 2023 CYTD, based on standard and available features offered.
Without the ones like you, who work tirelessly to keep things running, everything would suddenly stop. Hospitals, factories, schools, and power plants, they all depend on you. No matter the weather, emergency, or time of day, you're the ones who get it done. At Grainger, we're here for you with professional-grade industrial supplies. Count on real-time product availability and fast delivery. Call, clickgrainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
This is is Adam Gold.
What type of soup is Jason Kelce?
He would be like a chicken and dumplings.
Oh, chicken and dumpling. Yeah. Very nice. Maybe like an Italian wedding soup. What kind of soup would Travis Kelce be?
Travis, I feel like he'd be like a tomato bisque.
The Adam Gold Show.
It's the Adam Gold Show. I am Adam Gold. Victoria, producer of the program. Just a couple of minutes. ESPN Radio Lexington, Kentucky star Matthew Lawrence, because they are suddenly in coaching search mode to find the successor to John Calipari. Here's the thing. There are basically no coaching jobs in college basketball where a successor is an automatic success. You must hire the correct person. There just are no examples really in all sports where it doesn't matter who you hire. You still have to hire the right person. Otherwise, there won't be success. Notre Dame hasn't always got it right in football. It remains to be seen in spite of the success initially of both North Carolina and Duke, whether they got it right in basketball. I mean, all of this, we don't know. But North Carolina certainly didn't hire right immediately. Well, not immediately. After Dean Smith, Bill Guthridge was super successful, but you know, the more we get further removed from it, the more we kind of think that was probably an intended buffer between Dean and the next coach, and that was Matt Daugherty, and we know how that ended. And then Roy Williams, and, you know, we'll have to see if Hubert Davis is the long term. I love him. I think he's great. So I am on board with Hubert. I love John Shire. I think he's great, but we don't know because it's been so, it just hasn't been long enough to know. But Alabama football didn't always do it right, even though you would think, man, how did they ever lose? I didn't think there was ever going to be a time where Florida in football wasn't going to be great. How many coaches have they been through? Other than Steve Spurrier and Urban Meyer, how many coaches have they been through? No guarantees anywhere. One of the great TV faces and bass players. Were you a bass player in Eddie and the Cruisers? Matthew Lawrence, what was Sal's instrument in Eddie and the Cruisers?
You should know this, Adam.
No, I only know the soundtrack, which is a great soundtrack, by the way.
Yes, it was me on the bass.
All right. Can you play the bass?
I learned how to play all 10 of those songs.
Did you really?
From the movie. Oh, yeah.
All right.
I don't mess around, pal.
This is Matthew Lawrence from ESPN Radio in Lexington. So what's on the agenda today for you guys to talk about?
Well, I did my show from 10 to noon, which I always do, and nothing really going on around here. So I talked about Caitlin and the eclipse
right. And
my Yankees, you know, things like that.
It's the one thing. I wish you weren't a Yankees fan. That's fine. It's fine. You guys are off to a pretty good start. The Mets, I don't think the Mets have won a game. I'm not even sure.
Let's
let me get to this. How did it hit? I know this year didn't go well, didn't end well for Kentucky.
So oh boy.
How did it hit? Was it more relief, or was it like, are you really leaving us for Arkansas? How did it hit?
No, it was absolutely relief. Now, I will say a couple of things right off the bat. I've been here for 14 years
right. Covering
this basketball program. The year I came to Lexington was Cal's first year. We came at the same time.
Wow.
And to go through all of it with Big Blue Nation, as they're called, as right. Everyone knows, And I was, remember, I was at Duke for 10 years.
Yes.
I was in the ACC, and I've been a sports fan all my life. There is no fan base quite like this one.
Yeah.
None.
I agree.
People, if you have never been here and experienced, there's no fan base like this. So for the last, especially 3 or 4 years, it has been a growing, rumbling, and then full-blown, get Cal out of here. Pay him the $33 million.
Right.
The NCAA, the only thing Cal ever talked about was March is the only thing that mattered, the tournament.
Right.
And so when you lose 3 years in a row to a 15 seed, a 14 seed, and then in the second round to another low seed, things get ugly really quickly. And it was, you know, people wanted him gone, period. They were sick of all his talk about young guys. So we have a young team.
Right.
Well, then you get a team with veterans, which they had this year. And that didn't work. So it was met with, and I got to tell you, I'm old.
Right.
I'm a lot older than you. You don't have to say
you're
right
not a lot quickly. Older than me.
Okay. Yeah.
You're
yeah.
not a I'm lot just, older than me.
Okay. Whatever. Have I told you that I loved you and I missed you?
Yes.
Anyway, I always try to turn my light out at night at 11, and I usually fall asleep around then.
Right.
But last night, right before I turned the light out, I checked my phone for Twitter just to make sure, you know, what. And all of a sudden, I see a couple of things. Sounds like this Cal to Arkansas might be serious. And I went, what?
Yep.
And then I started reading. So I was up till probably 1. And then this morning, I wake up, because I'm old, at 5:30
right.
in the morning. And everything has gone completely berserk here. To the point, this is what I said on my show, Adam. You know how selfish John Calipari is? There was a South Carolina team undefeated winning a national championship.
Right.
There's a national championship game tonight between two number one seeds. There's a solar eclipse going on. And my Yankees are great. And he decides to drop this bombshell, well, not him, and it takes away from it's all anybody is talking about. It's unbelievable.
It's like A-Rod in the 2007 World Series.
Yeah,
right? That's what happened.
Kind of like that. I know. I remember. And it's just astounding what and now it has shifted immediately because this is a done deal. And I got to say, I have a couple of unimpeachable sources, and I'm not one of these media people that just lets, how about this, about, you know, letting rumors go and everything. I will tell you that I knew about this a little while ago. I didn't know it was going to happen this quickly.
Right.
But I also have heard from a couple of my friends who are in these positions that this has been coming for a long time. And I never talked about it because I don't do that. But it has started. It's happened again now. And all it is, obviously, is who is it going to be? Who are we
right.
getting? Who are we going to replace? We have people talking about Danny Hurley. All these people are lining up and Kentucky's just going to throw $20 million a year at them. Whatever it takes, just get them here. That's what this has become. So today, I'm guessing this won't be announced officially till tomorrow. But who knows? I heard you just say we don't know anything in terms of sports until it happens, really. And so all these rumors, and a lot of which are being floated by agents
sure.
of these coaches,
yeah.
Which always happens. So I don't know. My thought is I'm going to wait for the game tonight and just kind of sit here and laugh while I read Twitter. That's what I'm doing.
I'm going to suggest Dawn Staley as the next
you
coach at the University of Kentucky.
You know what? This is another reason I love you. On my children's lives,
right?
Not 10 minutes ago, a friend texted me and said, who do you want? And I texted Dawn Staley.
Yeah.
I swear to you.
Ball is ball.
I think it they'll never in a million years do it.
Of course not.
But I think I agree 100% with you. I think it would be, I mean, can you, well, we can only imagine, because it ain't happening.
Right. Of course, it's an easy thing to say. We know that right. We know they'll not do it. I do find it interesting. I don't think Danny Hurley's leaving Connecticut. I don't believe. Nate Oates has a buyout that is almost as large as John Calipari's was before accepting the Arkansas gig, or firing him to take the before he would take the Arkansas. Rick Pitino. I thought they hated Rick Pitino.
No, there's a big part of Big Blue Nation, even though there are some people that hate him because he went to Louisville, which is ridiculous. But there's a big part of Big Blue Nation that will always love Rick Pitino for rescuing them from the horrors of what happened before he got there and then winning a national championship right after he got here. So there's a big segment that will always love him.
Okay.
Here.
I still don't necessarily see him at his age, which is significantly older than you.
Right.
Leaving.
Actually, Adam.
What?
He's 3 years younger.
Well, stop. Just stop. Just don't give the game away, Matthew.
Oh, okay.
Don't give
sorry.
The Matthew Lawrence from
idiot.
ESPN Radio in Kentucky. My guess is that they're going to try to reach into the NBA. Much like they got Pitino away from the New York Knicks. That's where I ultimately think that they're going to go. But there's no guarantee.
A lot of people are talking about Billy Donovan.
Yeah.
I think that would be an incredible hire. But he one of the reasons he wanted out of college basketball, he didn't want to recruit anymore. He didn't want. That's why he's been in the NBA for a long time. And now, with the NIL stuff and the transfer portal, and
all right, final thing for you, because then we have to say goodbye. Do you think he'll do as well at Arkansas as he did at Kentucky? Better question: will he do as well at Arkansas as Eric Musselman did at Arkansas?
Wow, very good question. But that's why you're the best in the business.
Oh, stop.
I think Cal will do very, very well at Arkansas. You got to remember, a lot of this is NIL stuff. And Cal's biggest selling point was never Kentucky, ever.
Right.
It's about him getting 53 first-round draft picks in the NBA. And he'll still be able to do that. He's going to take all six of this number two recruiting class to Arkansas with him. None of those kids came here except Reed Shepard, who is a Kentucky kid. None of them came to Kentucky because of the school, no matter what they say. It was about Cal. And I think he'll still be able to do that. You know, we all know what kind of recruiter he is. So, and they will get from this Tyson family as much NIL money as they want.
Oh,
period.
Processed period. NIL money is the best. That is the best NIL money.
I got it.
All right.
That was a good one.
Give me a Masters pick before I have to say goodbye.
Oh, you ready for this?
Yes.
And I hate it. John Rahm.
Why would you hate it? John Rahm's a great player.
He's a great player, but I'm the biggest anti-Liv guy.
I know. I have talked about it.
You know.
By the way, Matthew does a great golf show, Backspin Golf. You should check it out.
Thanks, man.
You are the best, sir. I'll talk to you very soon.
Love you, pal.
Love you too, man. Peace. Matthew Lawrence, used to work at Duke, then went to Kentucky, 14 years covering that program. It's interesting to me because I said it when Cal first got to Kentucky, and I think they got to an Elite Eight. Then they won a national championship. But because of what you do, like immediately after getting there, you raise the expectations to a point where, like, those people just expected that to happen all the time. And then when you go through a couple of years where it's not as good, and these couple of years happen after you've been there 10, and they happen to be like 10 years since you won your national championship there, people go, well, maybe you're not for us anymore. That was a relationship that had run its course. It's a little different if you were like an alum, if you were always one of them. So, yeah, Kentucky needed to move on. Cal needed to move on. I think the answer is they will not win as much as they won under Eric Musselman. That's what I believe the answer is. I think John Calipari, as a basketball coach, has some limitations. As a coach, he has no limitations as a recruiter. And with the chicken money backing, which is going to give him $5 million of NIL money to spend on a roster every year, hey, that's fine. I have no problem with that. He'll get plenty of talent. Eric Musselman has been getting plenty of talent at the University of Arkansas. He is now at Southern Cal after Andy Enfield left Southern Cal to go to SMU as they come into the ACC for the first year. Yeah, exactly. SMU is an ACC school. That's how we have a tie back to it. But it's going to be hard for Cal because ultimately all you can do I think we're seeing it over time. Experience, guys who are good but not good enough to be pros, the experience of being a 3- and 4-year college player is probably the most important thing in an NCAA tournament run. You're seeing it with the two teams we've got tonight, experienced players. It's not, like, it's hard. It's hard to do it with 1-year guys. It is so difficult. And that's what Kentucky has been trying to do. And that's what Duke's been trying to do. At the very least, you must have a blend. Duke hasn't quite gotten to that blend the last couple of years. They're going to have to at some point. All right, still, so much to do. You know what? That's why I closed our conversation with Matthew Lawrence on a Masters pick, because this is Masters week. The Final Four, well, it's not over. We have two, and we have two behemoths, two giants later, and that's great. But it's Masters week, and I am ready, and so is my friend Scott Mishaw, Irish Examiner, Global Golf Post, and the brand new endeavor, the Daily Drive, a Substack. That's where we're all going to end up, at Substack at some point. Scott Mishaw joins us. Real quick, this is new. This is a brand new thing. I have so many things to promote for you.
Exactly. No, we started thinking about it earlier this year when Sports Illustrated and my colleagues who are in on it with me, you know, weren't sure what the future of that was going
right.
to be. And so we all thought, well, let's start trying this thing and see if we can get some traction going with that. And it's turned out it's been pretty fun. We just started it last week. And, you know, it's been a lot of Masters stuff and some, you know, anniversary stuff, looking back at the things we wrote 20 years ago when Phil Mickelson won
right
here and stuff like that. And so, and we were having a good time with it. So it's fun. You know, we can kind of be more of ourselves and less formal on it.
All right. There's a lot of things I want to get to, and for the first major of the year, but has the Augusta National Committee approved the solar eclipse?
Not only have they approved it, everybody that came through the gates today was handed glasses with Masters logos.
Are you joking? That's awesome.
I'm not joking. They honestly think of absolutely everything here. And I can't wait. I cannot wait to go out at 3:08 this afternoon or whenever it's supposed to be, as close to total as it's going to get here, which is about 80%.
Right.
And see everybody on this property staring at the sky with their little like 3D glasses on. It's going to be hilarious.
That will be great. Apparently, from what I've been able to gather, the best viewing is at Amen Corner.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I'm sure it will be. I would have thought it would be at the top of the course near the clubhouse.
Right.
I'm not going to get all the way down to Amen Corner with all those people that aren't looking at me. and they're probably going to step on you. But it will be the best time to go shopping in the merchandise shop, I think, because the lines this year have been outrageous, sometimes as long as 2.5 hour long.
Wow.
Just to get in there. During the ANWA on Saturday, it was unbelievable. And today, it was well over an hour
for people
to get in there. So 3 o'clock, shopping time.
Perfect. Not Amen Corner to watch the sky grow dark.
Exactly.
All right, let's get to some golf things. I'm going to start with something that probably isn't going to result in anybody contending for the title, but this is could be the 24th consecutive year that Tiger Woods makes the cut at the Masters. What is the real significance of that?
Well, I mean, it obviously shows how comfortable he is here, considering everything that he has gone through in the last 10 years. And on the occasions when he has played, he still manages to make the weekend. Yeah. Even last year when he ended up withdrawing after the third round got postponed and moved on, and he was a mess. He still was playing on the weekend.
Yep.
And so I think it just shows you, I mean, how much he cares about this place, and there's no quit in him when he gets here, even when he can barely walk.
Yeah, it's funny. You could tell how much it hurt just to walk the property, and for people who have never been there, present company included, we can't tell. We have no concept. All I know is talking to you, talking to other friends who have been there, that you cannot even imagine how hilly the property. It's a difficult walk for him. Soon as they were doubling it up, you knew that he wasn't going to be able to do it. Frankly, when was the last time he finished an event?
That's a very good question, and I believe, I mean, if we're not counting the non-official events like
Hero
in the Bahamas and the Hero,
you would have to
go back almost the Masters 2 years ago.
Yeah. He's not finishing events. I mean, he didn't finish Riviera because he got a cold.
That's right. He didn't finish PGA Championship because he got hurt again.
Right.
The 2 years ago. And then, of course, after the Masters last year, he didn't play anymore. So, you're right. It's probably been 2 years since an official event has been finished by him, because he really wasn't, I mean, his leg wasn't good enough.
Right.
It should be good enough now. I mean, he's saying it's good enough.
All right, let me move on. Frankly, Tiger is probably better suited now for LIV Golf, with it being only a 54-hole event. But I saw already the dumb story of the week, and I'm embarrassed for the reporters who took the bait from the LIV Golf PR firm, whatever they are. Can a LIV golfer win the Masters? Which, of course, is dumb, since the defending champion now plays at LIV, and champion in 2018 and 2017, they've got, like, I don't know how many Masters champs. They got 13 players in the field. They all deserve to be here based on past play, current form, all of that, Cam Smith. It's really dumb, but it's used to kind of say, see, we have great golfers. Nobody's debated that. That just isn't a debate that smart people are having. But what chance do you give Scott Mischa, as I take the bait too, sort of, for a LIV golfer to hoist this trophy?
Well, I think they're fairly strong. In fact, I think one of three people is going to win it, and two of them are LIV golfers. So I think it's going to be either Scottie Scheffler, Jon Rahm repeating, or Brooks Koepka.
Right.
So I think they're the three strongest golfers coming into this week. Rory did play well last week, but Rory's got, he's got things in his head.
Yes, he does.
Here. And so I just think that'll come back to bite him at some point. But I would think this could be one of the chalkiest Masters in a while, with those three guys as, I think, pretty prohibitive favorites. But then you still got Dustin Johnson, who's playing terrific. I mean, he just won here, 4 years ago.
Yes.
You still got Patrick Reed, who can crop up and ruin any week at any time. You've got Cam Smith, who has not been playing his best, but I mean, that short game,
yeah.
Come on. How do you rule any of them out?
No.
Sergio just played very well last week. Of course they can win. Of course the guys that they have, they're sending here are capable of winning.
Yeah. It's
so, at least 10 of them.
The whole conversation was so funny and transparent. You know what? It's fine. It gives us an opportunity to talk about it. And that's good. Jordan Spieth, who we thought based on his win and his near win the next year until the 12th hole, which is probably always going to be in his head, which he's not alone. I'm sure it's in a lot of players' heads. Where is his game at this point? I mean, I want to believe that Jordan Spieth can summon something because he is one of those few players that does move the needle with his presence. Where is his game? And his buddy Justin Thomas, too.
Right. Well, Justin Thomas's game is a little further away, I think, than Jordan's, especially when you come here. Jordan's going to be in the mix here. He just is. Even when he plays, wildly erratic golf anywhere else, he'll come here and he can play wildly erratic golf and she'll shoot 4 under par. So I think that this is a course that suits the kind of golfer he's kind of become, which is a little all over the map.
Right.
I mean, my God, you saw the shot in Texas where he ended up on a roof that was like he was trying to hit downtown.
Tough lie. It's a tough lie.
It was a tough lie. It was a tough lie, but it was still hilarious.
Yeah, absolutely.
And Jordan, I still think, is one of the most dynamic golfers to watch play because you never know what's going to happen. And even when he looks like he has nothing, he finds something, and then he'll miss a 3-foot putt. So he's an interesting character. I still think he's one of the best golfers in the world, and I still think when you come here, he's one of the 10 guys who has the best chance of winning. Because this place brings something out in him, and you're allowed to be a little bit wild.
Scott Mishaw, Global Golf Post, Irish Examiner, The Daily Drive, the new Substack. We're actually going to talk to your one of your colleagues on that tomorrow in Bob Herrick. I don't know if you know this. He's written another book, but we'll talk to him about it. So one of the things I love talking to you about with regards to the Masters is the food offerings. And I know you mentioned, I believe it was last year, how disappointed you were and that they took away the peach ice cream. Has that come back? Do they have any new offerings? Have the prices gone up?
The prices for the sandwiches are exactly the same as they've always been. There's been a $1 increase in alcoholic beverages. I think a beer is now $6. The high-end beer is $6, as is a wine, which they're offering now on the course.
Sure.
And that's the most expensive thing on the menu.
Unbelievable.
So it is. And an element that I really like that they've had the last couple of years are cheese straws. Those sort of crunchy little sharp cheddar-y cracker things.
Right, yeah.
They're fantastic.
Are they?
And that's become my new go-to snack, and I'm going to eat way too many of them this week. But I'm old school. I still like all the old stuff. I still like the egg salad. I still like the Master's Club, the chicken sandwich. They're still the best. All the good food, you can probably get anywhere around here, and they serve us in a nice restaurant here in our Ritz-Carlton Press Building. I would still rather get the sandwiches.
My problem with cheese straws, I can't drink through them, but that's me because I don't get the product. Scott Mishaw.
I don't get why they're called straws.
Yeah, I don't understand that. It bothers me. Scott Mishaw, Global Golf Post, Irish Examiner, The Daily Drive, the Substack. Hey, thank you very much for the time, my man. I'll talk to you soon. Enjoy. You already made your three picks, and I appreciate that. And I wouldn't be surprised if they were 1, 2, 3 at the end. Scottie Scheffler wakes up, and he's in the top three. So thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
Scott Mishaw, he's covered the Masters for like 25 years or something like that. It's crazy. He actually asked me after that if he was surprised I didn't mention Virginia basketball. And I really wanted to say, because I'm trying to forget it, Scott.
Right.
Trying to forget Virginia basketball. All right, we have to place wagers. We have a national championship game tonight. It is really between the two best teams all year, Connecticut and Purdue. All respect to Houston, who had a great season. Connecticut and Purdue were the two best teams start to finish this year. And they each have really great big men. So we don't have to worry about how is Connecticut going to guard Zach Edey.
Yeah.
They have a body to do that.
Right.
No other team has that.
No.
Right? Alabama couldn't really handle Connecticut inside. Alabama's bigs are different. But
across our state, we embrace and support fair housing to stamp out discrimination in all forms. As realtors, we believe fairness is worth fighting for, and we won't stop until the fight is won. Celebrating Fair Housing Month, North Carolina Realtors. We open doors to everyone. Paid for by North Carolina Realtors.
It's playoff time in the NBA and the NHL. Baseball's in full swing, and FanDuel is your place to bet on every game. Adam Gold here. And right now, new customers can get $200 in bonus bets guaranteed when you make your first $5 wager. Because you know me. FanDuel.com, promo code AGS to sign up. FanDuel.com, promo code AGS to sign up. Then you can bet on anything. Slap shots, home runs, slam dunks, all on an app that is safe, secure, and easy to use. $200 in bonus bets await when you place your first $5 wager. Visit FanDuel.com, promo code AGS to get started. FanDuel is America's number one sportsbook. Must be 21 and older and present in North Carolina. First online real money wager only. $10 deposit required. Bonuses issued as non-withdrawable bonus bets that expire 7 days after receipt. Restrictions apply. See full terms at FanDuel.com/sportsbook. Gambling problem? Call 877-718-5543 or visit morethanagame.nc.gov.
The Body Armor State Games are coming to Charlotte this June. Registration is open to athletes of all ages and skill levels in 25 different sports. The Body Armor State Games features 13,000 athletes and 700 teams. Don't miss out on North Carolina's largest sports festival of the year. Visit BodyArmorStateGames.org today. The Body Armor State Games are proud to partner with Truist, Harris Teeter, and Blue Cross and Blue Shield of North Carolina.
Everyone goes through tough times, and everyone can get through them as long as they don't have to do it alone. Dial 988 if you need someone to talk to. Get what you need to get to a better place. Together, we'll find the care that works best for you. We're here 24/7. Call, text, or chat 988. 988. Let's get through it together. Brought to you by the North Carolina Department of Health and Human Services.
Trust ACT Construction Equipment and Bandit Wood Chippers and Stump Grinders to position your tree service for success. ACT Construction Equipment is your authorized dealer for sales, service, parts, and rentals for Bandit Wood Chippers and Stump Grinders. ACT Construction Equipment has been your authorized dealer for Bandit Equipment for over 10 years. Visit one of our 6 North and South Carolina locations or actce.com for more details on Bandit Wood Chippers and Stump Grinders. ACT Construction Equipment, always the right equipment for the job.
It's the first day of the first grade, and she found a new best friend. It's a laid-back Sunday afternoon you wish would never end.
The homemade taste of bluebell and good friends gathered round. The good old days are being made right now.
St. Louis brought the world gooey butter cake. Now Bluebell brings us gooey butter cake ice cream, a cake batter ice cream with a luscious cream cheese swirl and gooey butter cake pieces. Mmm, it's the gateway to the best in pints and half gallons.
The good old days are being made right now.
The good old days are being made right now.
Look for Bluebell ice cream at your local grocer and pick up your favorite flavor today.
This is Adam Gold.
If the kids want to get on the floor, they're going to get on the floor.
They'll find a way.
There are too many ways to get on the floor.
Yeah, and they've been drinking Liquid Courage all day.
And that is very possible. But only the ones that are old enough.
Only the older ones, yes. So,
the Adam Gold Show.
I know it's over for me.
show. Mike DeCourcy is going to join us in about 25 minutes from Phoenix. We'll talk Final Four with him. And then we'll be joined by Darren Revelle, who, you know, we've talked to Darren a bunch of times on this program. He's got a new venture about sports, not just sports, but collectibles. If you are a collector of famous items, baseball cards, then you're going to want to know what Darren is up to right now because it's tailored to you. We can also kind of gauge the value of Caitlin Clark and what it means to women's basketball or basketball going forward. But right now, it's time to stretch and then place wagers.
Okay, so as you can imagine, this one's got a theme. It's the eclipse.
Of course.
In case you haven't heard about it, it's happening today around 3, so prepare yourself. Also, one thing that you should prepare for, I had no idea this was a legitimate thing, but there was a study that found there is a brief spike in accidents that happen during an eclipse. So this
Yeah,
they were looking. It was about a 31% jump from the 2017 eclipse that happened, which translates as an extra crash every 25 minutes and one additional fatality every 95. So be careful if you're driving. What they think it's because of people driving unfamiliar routes or people trying to speed to get home somewhere so they can watch it, or people who are like caught off guard when it happens
people
and you're driving.
People are staring at the sun while they drive.
Right.
I thought that was obvious.
Which they don't recommend you doing
it
that.
It doesn't take that many people to raise the percentages.
No, it does not at all. So, yes. And they also advise those who are on the, quote, path of totality, which stretches from Texas to Maine, to be careful as well. So.
Oh, I thought that was like a personal thing. If you are on the path of totality.
That's all different. Seventh inning. So, yeah, but that's all we have time for today. So be careful if you are driving around then. Now, it's time to play some bets.
Let's
place
do it.
Your bets. Place your bets. Here we are. I bet you slice into the woods $100.
Gambling is illegal at Bushwood, sir, and I never slide.
Yeah. Okay, you can owe me. I owe you one.
All right, let's get right to it. We'll forget the weekend since nothing happened that we liked on the weekend.
So frustrating. Why do I not place, like, real units on my MMA bets?
You have access.
I went two for three with my MMA bets. I know. I always feel like I jinx myself when I do that, though. So today I'm going to start with basketball. Purdue and Connecticut, they're meeting. Give me any player to record a triple-double. That is plus 4,000. Any player?
What, in the NBA?
No, in the Purdue and Connecticut game tonight.
Okay.
So, yes, any player.
Oh,
I
wow.
still think, like.
There's no NBA tonight.
No. Mm-mm.
We're out.
Yep.
Okay. 4,000.
Yeah. I know. That's what I thought.
Doesn't seem like.
Too far
be,
of a stretch.
It should be better than plus 4,000.
I would think so.
Lower, but hey, by all means.
I know.
All right, so here's what I'm doing tonight. I think Connecticut's going to win.
Mm-hmm.
But I think this is going to be a classic game. So give me Purdue plus 6.5.
Okay.
And I think we stay under 144.5. So Purdue at the under is plus 270.
No, nice.
Yeah.
Okay.
Why not?
If you like it. This one, I can't believe this is still plus money. Go into the ice. Vegas Golden Knights, Vancouver Canucks. How is Jack Eichel still plus money for an anytime goal scorer? Give it to me, plus 170.
All right. I'm just going to give you two winners tonight in the NHL. There's only two games. Like, everybody's watching basketball. Penguins are on the road in Toronto. I think Pittsburgh wins that game. And I think Vancouver beats Vegas at home. So give me the Pens and the Canucks in a parlay at plus 295. There you go. We'll talk about the Canes tomorrow.
Raleigh to Boone, Charlotte to Chapel Hill. Your Carolina is covered. Adam Gold on the North Carolina Sports Network.
Hey everybody, Tim Donnelly here, and I want you to look down at your wrist right now. If you don't see an absolutely awesome watch that you can be proud of and want to show off, You want to listen to me about what I'm about to tell you when it comes to Fox & Bailey's watch shop located inside Bailey's Fine Jewelry at their Village District location. You can get yourself an Omega, a brand new Omega from their Omega Boutique, which is the second largest of its kind in the entire country. That means Speedmasters, the model of Omega that is worn on the moon by multiple different astronauts. They call it the Moonwatch. Or something like a Seamaster. You may have seen it on a very particular spy movie that everyone is very familiar with. They also have pre-owned Rolexes over in their watch shop. They have all of these different brands. I have a G-Shock on my wrist as we speak right now. You can get one there. It's all at Fox & Bailey, located inside the Bailey's Fine Jewelry Village District location. You should have something you're proud of on your wrist.
It's bow time. Something new just dropped at Bojangles. Take the bold taste of a crispy golden chicken supreme that's been seasoned to perfection, then add dill pickles, Carolina Gold barbecue sauce, and a toasted bun that's great on the go. What do you get? You get a Bose Bird Dog. In fact, you can grab two of them for $5. So when you're on the go, headed to practice, or need a snack, grab a Bose Bird Dog. Hurry in before they're gone, available for a limited time. It's bow time.
There's no time like bow time, but sometimes it's go time. No time to stop. Introducing Bojangles' new Bird Dog, a seasoned to perfection Bojangles Chicken Supreme, dill pickles, Carolina Gold barbecue sauce, all on a toasted bun. Great on the go. Try two Bird Dogs for just $5 or a two Bird Dog combo for just $8. Hurry, Bo's Bird Dogs are available for a limited time only. When you're hungry for flavor and value, it's bow time.
Making dinner, trimming your hair, mowing the lawn. Sure, you can do it all yourself, but why? At Auto Bell Car Wash, our team cleans your whole car from the inside out in 15 minutes or less. We do the work so you don't have to.
People can tell when you are Auto Bell.
Were you forced to get a nosebleed mortgage rate in the past year? Loan Pronto is here to rescue you. Hey, it's Dennis Cox. Listen, if your mortgage rate is over 7, you're going to be in heaven with Loan Pronto's zero-cost refi. You can cut your house payment by hundreds of dollars with zero closing costs. Rates have come down, so you can say goodbye to that bad loan you got stuck with. Loan Pronto's now got APRs with fixed rates in the fives. One couple just did this and saved over $550 a month with no appraisal and closed in 10 days. So, don't live with that stupid rate a day longer. You can lock in at a lower rate now with no cost and very little paperwork. Loan Pronto, your easy button for lower rates and no closing cost loans. Call now and see how much lower you can get your house payment. Refi now and you can even skip your next two house payments altogether. 919-381-1760. 919-381-1760. LoanPronto.com. 919-381-1760. NMLS 1661781. Subject to lender approval. Equal housing lender.
Hey everyone, it's Ted from Consumer Cellular, the guy in the orange sweater, and this is your wake-up call. If you're paying too much for wireless service, you don't have to keep having that nightmare. Consumer Cellular has the same fast, reliable coverage as the leading carriers for less. And for a limited time, new customers receive their second month free when they sign up and use promo code MONTHFREE by May 31st. So why keep spending more than you have to? Seriously, wake up and call 1-888-FREEDOM or visit ConsumerCellular.com.
Taxes, fees, and other third-party charges will apply. See website for additional details.
This hour on the Triangle Sports Leader is brought to you by the Richie Law Firm Injury Lawyers.
You can feel the madness!
Go to gotbryan.com. That's gotbryan.com.
WCMC HD1 Holly Springs. Take us with you on radio, web, app, Alexa, and YouTube. 99.9 The Fan, the Triangle Sports Leader.
NC State, as much as I'm so happy that it, you know, kind of rejuvenated my brother's championship from 83. I think that got to the kids when they opened the game today. They played like deers in the headlights for the first 8 minutes, and I think all of that was a little bit too much. They should have gone. They've been playing with house money for, you know, for, what, 3 weeks now. ACC tournament in the first two rounds of the NCAA tournament, and today it looked like everything. They suddenly realized, oh my God, we're playing for history and the memory in 1983 and Jimmy V, and they didn't play nearly like they have.
It's the Adam Gold Show. I am Adam Gold. Victoria's here. We'll talk basketball with Mike DeCourcy of the Sporting News. He's in Phoenix. We will do that in about 15 minutes. That was Bob Valvano, who I actually know fairly well and saw in Phoenix at the Final Four. I disagree with the why of NC State not playing well. I don't think it had anything to do with any of those things. I don't think it had a single thing to do with 83 or carrying that around. I think they got beat by a better team. I think they got beat in a game that they could have won. Did they possibly run out of gas? I mean, theoretically, they had played Sunday. You should have been able to re-energize by Saturday. They just did not shoot well. But I thought they played hard. I thought they played, their game plan was sound. If they make a couple of more, you're not going to make all of those layups, but if you make a couple of more of the layups, if Mo Diarra finishes the dunk, ultimately it's just 2 points, so I'm not going to assign that much importance to it. But ultimately, if they had just shot the ball better, I think the game is different. What State was never able to do was put scoreboard pressure on Purdue. It was always sitting there. Like, DJ Burns made a bucket. There was probably 12 minutes left in regulation. And you could almost feel a run coming because Purdue had turned it over a couple of times in a row. And I think Burns cut the lead to, might have been 6, but I kind of think it was 8. But you could feel a run coming because Purdue was having a hard time scoring. But State couldn't make their shots either. And ultimately, as Sidney Lowe, friend of the program now, has said many times, you got to make shots. And I really believe it came down to that. That and Purdue has been all year long one of the two best teams. And we're going to see those two teams play tonight. So somebody say, you rarely get this in college basketball. I think that's true. You rarely do get the clear two best teams all year long meeting. Now, what you clearly get is one of the, probably two of the best teams, but not the clear one versus two. You don't usually get that. And that's what we have tonight, and that will be great for the men's game after the women threw all those stars at us for 3 weeks. I miss it already.
Me too.
I miss the fascination of it already.
So fun. So great.
They were. Those games were incredible, and that is where we will begin in the Wall of Sound.
The Wall of Sound is a function of this studio. There's no doubt about it.
So, before Iowa could lose to South Carolina, NC State was tasked with taking their swings. 32-31 at half? 1 point game at half?
Yeah.
Like, no joke, I was doing hurricane stuff, right? I believe it was first intermission maybe when the game was at halftime. And I'm like, all right, Wolfpack within one.
Staying in there.
And we came out of the intermission, and I looked over like, wait a second, why is it a 16-point lead?
Yeah, what happened?
Am I having trouble with math here? That's what South Carolina does. Wes Moore, the head coach of NC State.
Just like I said, just to be able to have such an inside-outside game. There was times, we were trying to maybe double from the weak side on Cardoza or maybe dig from the ball side and try to get it out of there. But if she buries you so deep that, even doubling's hard to do.
Yeah, they've got weapons everywhere. And they had a lot of freshmen, a lot of new faces as well. So good for them. They were just awesome and an absolute pleasure to watch. And I am Team Dawn Staley. And then after the game, Dawn Staley, the head coach at South Carolina, said what probably a lot of people who have been paying attention this year probably felt.
really would just like to say, I have to congratulate Iowa on an incredible season. Awesome, awesome. And I want to personally thank Caitlin Clark for lifting up our sport. She carried a heavy load for our sport, and it just is not going to stop here on the collegiate tour. But when she is the number one pick in the WNBA draft, she's gonna lift that league up as well. So Caitlin Clark, if you're out there, you are one of the GOATs of our games, and we appreciate you.
Here's what's cool about what Dawn Staley said at the very end there, is that there was an online debate, which of course filtered over into television, about can you be the GOAT, the greatest of all time, without winning a championship? And it was making people angry when Breanna Stewart, who won four of those at UConn, and Dawn, who didn't win any at Virginia, mentioned that, yeah, in order to be the GOAT, you have to win a title. Jay Williams on ESPN took all sorts of heat by saying she's got to win something first. Well, I would say that getting to a Final Four 2 years in a row is in many ways winning something. But we can all have differing opinions on that. What there really isn't a difference of opinion on is the fact that she carried the flag for women's basketball and in many ways women's athletics for an entire season. Maybe longer. So television ratings, I can't wait to see the numbers from yesterday. Sunday afternoon, ABC. I can't wait to see what those are. But what was it, 15 million watched or 14 million or whatever it was?
Maybe.
A whole bunch of millions.
I was one.
Well, I absolutely was one as well. I wish I would have been able to actually pay attention. We had the South Carolina NC State game on in the hotel room where I was doing storm watch and aftermath and all that. But I wasn't able to focus as intently on it. But man, was that something else. And by the way, Caitlin Clark was happy to hear that from Dawn Staley.
I think anytime somebody like Coach Staley is able to recognize you and what you did for the game is pretty special. And obviously she's somebody I, you know, respect so much. I respect what she's done for South Carolina. I respect what she did as a player for our game. And, you know, anytime you can get the praises of her is pretty special. So that means a lot.
I mean, right now she is one of the top voices in the sport. There's no question about that.
Absolutely.
All right, so let me get to the men's basketball tournament. Again, Purdue versus Connecticut tonight. If you're listening in Raleigh, you can hear it on 99.9 The Fan, and I'm sure across many of our stations along this vast network. DJ Burns, NC State big man, had a great time. It was obvious until it ended.
Man, just to be a part of this has been everything I could have asked for, man. Didn't go the way we wanted to go out, but man, this has been an experience like no other. It's something, you know, that I've wanted my whole life, and to be able to do it with the group of people that we have is just amazing, man. And the city, we're just glad we could bring the culture back to Raleigh and bring it back for state fans, man. They've been waiting for a long time, and I hope we give them something to, you know, build off of next year.
So that last part remains to be seen. We don't know if there is going to be, if this was a building block or a one-off. But hopefully the profile that DJ Burns and DJ Horn and others helped, you know, elevate to, hopefully it will. Here's DJ Horn on how it all came together.
It's been fun, you know, every step of the way, every win that we've gotten, it's felt like a championship. To see all the joy and the happiness that it's brought, you know, our university, our city and everything, how many people got behind us, not just from NC State, but the whole country. It just shows, you know, when you come together and, you know, stick together, you know, what you can do as a team. And I'm just, you know, grateful that I was a part of it all.
You were a huge part of it all.
Oh, yeah.
That was a fun 3 weeks of basketball.
Definitely new state fans around the country.
Super fun 3 weeks of basketball. and a fan base here locally that needed it.
Yes, and travels well.
Oh, they do. That was awesome to see.
That was great.
I forget the name of the place. To call it a bar would be miscasting it. It was sort of, it was obviously a bar, but it had bocce. It had pickleball.
Nice.
It had, I believe there was sand volleyball. I'm not going to call it beach volleyball because it wasn't a beach.
Yeah.
I hate that. But it had all sorts of things like that and just a big open atmosphere. And I state bought it out.
Mm-hmm.
Some, whatever, maybe it was Wolfpack Club. I don't know.
Yeah.
Bought it out. There had to be, I don't know, 300
yeah.
state fans there. I'm really just guessing.
I know.
But NC State fans were everywhere.
I think it was around Hillsborough Street or something here in Raleigh that they just blocked off people everywhere.
Well, yeah,
they did.
They shut down Hillsborough Street.
It was great.
I'm sorry they didn't win. It was a winnable game because it was there for them. They just didn't shoot the ball well enough. But we have the national championship game that it probably has the two best teams in the country all year.
Yeah.
In it. We'll talk to Mike DeCourcy about that. In a second, he will join us from the sporting news from Phoenix next.
Serving it up hot and fresh every day. Adam Gold on the North Carolina Sports Network.
Listen to 99.9 The Fan every afternoon during the drive for your chance to see the storm surge in person. It's our 10K playoff payout. Try your luck at playoff tickets by discovering the golden puck. And like last year, take your ultimate shot at $10,000.
Let's go!
Listen for the 10K playoff payout, driven by your Carolina Ford dealer. For great offers on a new Ford truck or SUV, see your Carolina Ford dealer today.
What up, North Carolina? FanDuel is America's number one sports book, and just because our interest in the Final Four might have waned doesn't mean we don't have interest in other things. NHL playoffs a couple of weeks away. NBA playoffs, same thing, about a week or so away. Major League Baseball, full swing, so to speak. FanDuel.com, promo code AdamGold. Right now, new customers get $200 in bonus bets, guaranteed. Win or lose when you make your first $5 wager. FanDuel.com, promo code AdamGold. $200 in bonus bets awaits, guaranteed. Win or lose when you make your first $5 wager. FanDuel is America's number one sports book. Take advantage of it. Must be 21 and older and present in North Carolina. First online real money wager only, $10 deposit required. Bonuses issued as non-withdrawable bonus bets that expire 7 days after receipt. Restrictions apply. See full terms at FanDuel.com/sportsbook. Gambling problem? Call 877-718-5543 or visit morethanagame.nc.gov.
QC Kinetics announces the arrival of National Medical Director Dr. Mitchell Sheinkup, an acclaimed orthopedic surgeon with 2 decades of experience and extensive research in regenerative medicine.
And I was one of the first orthopedic surgeons to do it. And at the same time, I integrated clinical research that's resulted in several publications that are really directing the future of regenerative medicine. I was drawn to QC Kinetics after I reviewed their protocols, and everything they were doing is consistent with my own approach.
Today, Dr. Sheinkup leads the entire team of medical professionals at QC Kinetics, taking this exciting medical breakthrough to a whole new level.
What we are doing at QC Kinetics is transforming lives.
Get lasting joint pain relief. Call QC Kinetics now for your free consultation.
This is the future of medicine.
Call QC Kinetics 919-400-5473. That's 919-400-5473. In Cary, Clayton, Raleigh, and Wake Forest, 919-400-5473.
What are you doing?
I'm training for the new Ultimate Dash Scratch-Offs. I could get a chance to dash through a warehouse full of prizes.
That explains the shopping cart.
Plus, I could win up to $2 million in cash.
And that explains the tuxedo.
I'm chafing.
Feel the rush with new Ultimate Dash Scratch-Offs from the North Carolina Education Lottery. Must be 18 to play. Approximate overall odds of winning are 1 in 3.78. Problem gambling helpline, 877-718-5543.
Adam Gold here from my friend Dr. Lori Travers and Travers LASIK, the Triangle's only LASIK specialist who can take you to 20/20 vision, and it's more affordable than you think. 0% financing for 24 months is available. And in the spring, giving you $1,000 off. That's right, $1,000 off in the spring. All you got to do is call 919-510-6830, 919-510-6830, Travers LASIK. See what you've been missing.
We all know what UV rays can do to our skin, but they can also do damage to your car. Keep that from happening with 303 Protectant. 303 Protectant keeps the sun's harmful rays from causing fading and cracking in rubber, plastic, or vinyl surfaces. From the dashboard to the tires, 303 Protectant keeps your car looking new, longer. Get 303 Protectant today at AutoZone. Visit 303radio.com for more information.
This is Adam Gold.
There are people out there that just, you must draft a quarterback.
Yeah, why? Don't want a quarterback?
Exactly. What is wrong with you? Oh, you don't want apple pie?
Right.
Come on.
No, maybe I like brownies, okay?
I don't want it there.
The temptation.
I don't need it because I can convince myself, apple's healthy.
Right.
The Adam Gold Show.
It's the Adam Gold Show. I am Adam Gold. Victoria is producing the program. We are less than an hour out from the solar eclipse. Mike DeCourcy of the Sporting News is joining us now from Phoenix, where the solar eclipse comes earlier in the day because, Pacific time. Are you prepared for the solar eclipse, or is that just a euphemism for what we're going to have tonight with two guys banging bodies who are over 7 feet tall?
Yes, I think that's what I'm preparing for over any eclipses. I don't think I will be in position to see any eclipses tonight. If I can sleep through that, I would probably do that.
Oh, that's sleep. That sounds like a great idea. I am told, though, that you're not allowed to look directly into the eclipse unless you're looking through, like, the bottom of a cereal box. They actually said that on TV. Like, if you don't have glasses, you could just poke holes in, like, paper or cardboard or something and look through it. I don't understand why that's better.
I think you're supposed to, like, look into, like, the reflection of the cardboard or the paper and not, like, look through the hole and then straight at the sun. I don't think that's what they mean.
I don't know what they're doing. By the way, I saw a photo shoot for the Big Ten Network. Why are you, Dan Revson and Andy Katz, or Dave Revson and Andy Katz, why are you guys all standing on boxes?
First of all, I don't know how those photos got out. I'm going to blame Katz. Something tells me it's his fault.
Probably.
I think it was yesterday, to be fully confessional here, Revson and I stood on those boxes because they wanted the shot to be right, and Robbie Hummel is 6'8".
Okay.
But today it was because they wanted a particular element of the stadium in the background, so it enabled them to shoot that. So you could see. I don't know if it was the Final Four logo or the stadium logo or exactly what it was that they wanted in the shot. But that was the reason for the positioning today.
All right, let's get to some basketball with Mike DeCourcy of the Sporting News, and we'll stop talking about the solar eclipse and having three distinguished gentlemen standing on boxes for no reason. I thought it was there for them to take in the second half. I thought they defended Purdue incredibly well in the second half. If they had just made a couple of more shots and maybe applied some scoreboard pressure, which unfortunately they were never able to do in the second half, I thought that was a game State could have won. How did you see the second half especially?
Well, I think they had a chance. I think that what by Purdue's design happened was that the people taking the shots in question that you're speaking of primarily were not the players that NC State would have preferred.
Right.
They did a really nice job. I honestly, in watching the game, especially because you're watching it at the level where our press seats are, it felt like DJ Horn had like 7 threes.
Right.
Because he was making jump shots. But then you look at the box score and then you're like, he's made 2.
Yeah.
And then you realize that Lance Jones has been running him off the three-point line all night and forcing him to take two-point shots. And DJ Horn did a great job with that. He made a bunch of them.
Yeah.
But they weren't worried about giving up 18-foot shots. They felt like in the end that they would prevail if that was the diet that NC State had to exist on. And in the end, the Purdue calculus was correct.
There's no question. State, here's the thing. State was not a team that was reliant on the three ball all year long. They won a game this year without making a three. I think they were, was it Syracuse or whatever it was? They were 0-for-8 from three-point range in a game that they won and won comfortably. So it wasn't a team that was completely reliant on it, but against Purdue, I mean, I understand why you want to do it because they're going to do it. And I right. thought it was interesting because I thought they did a pretty good job. I know Zach Edey had 20 points, but 14 of those came in the first half. I thought they did a very good job at limiting the damage. They just couldn't stop the three-point line because Purdue shot 40% from there and 40% from two.
You know, it's funny. I've been doing this now for this is my 34th Final Four, and I'm trying to remember off the top of my head, probably about five of those ballpark were in basketball arenas, NBA arenas,
yeah.
that type of thing. And the other 29 or so have been in stadiums. And what amazes me is that there are still people who believe it's harder to shoot in stadiums.
No.
If it were harder, then all NC State would have had to do was send five guys to guard Zach Edey and let Purdue shoot all day from
right.
the three-point line. And they'd never make any because it's harder and it's impossible and there's a bad background and all that. But the reality of it is that guys adjust.
Yeah.
I always said back when it became a controversy, these guys grow up playing in playgrounds with no nets. And
right.
you're worried that they're not going to be able to shoot the ball into a glass backboard with a net in the stadium background.
They played a game on an aircraft carrier.
Yes.
Right.
Yeah, that was a little harder though because the wind started to blow and it's a little bit different. But what you saw was a Purdue team that has shot the basketball exceptionally well all year,
yep.
number 2 in the country in 3-point shooting, and they had a rough day against Tennessee. They made a big one. Lance Jones made a big one with 2.5 minutes left that kind of put the game in Purdue's pocket, but. They were only 3 of 15 in that game, and so I understand why if you're playing in that game, your first priority is to shut down Edey, and they did do a good job with that. 20 points for Zach Edey the game after he had scored 41
right.
was a really nice defensive effort, especially when DJ, because of fouls and other things, was only able to be involved at a marginal level. I thought Middlebrooks did a tremendous
yeah.
job with his efforts defensively against Zach Edey.
Yeah, he did, and I thought by pressuring the perimeter that NC State did more of in the second half, I think they forced Edey a little bit further out to receive the ball, which at times made him put the ball on the floor, and as soon as he dribbled it once, State was swarming to the ball. They knocked the ball away a bunch. But ultimately what we're going to have tonight is the two best teams, and
yeah.
State would have had to have pulled off something maybe more miraculous than winning 5 games in 5 days in the ACC tournament to beat Purdue ultimately. But we're going to see the two best teams in the country. And Connecticut has a guy who can at least attempt to body Zach Edey. He's big. He's physical. He's a great player. How do you see this?
You know, I did not know this, but I was on Big Ten Today with Dave Revson. And he pointed out this is the first time in the history of the NCAA tournament. Do the math on how many games that is. The tournament's been going on for more than 90 years.
Right.
The first time two guys 7'2" or taller have met at any stage of the tournament. Just a staggering statistic. And the first time for 2 7-footers in the final since a couple of guys named Patrick Ewing and Hakeem Olajuwon.
Oh, wow.
So really a cool thing to have that. 2-1 seeds, the number one and number two teams in KenPom.com ratings. It's exactly what we would have asked for when this tournament began, and really exciting because of that. I certainly give the advantage to Connecticut because starting with their positional size, 6'7", 6'5", 6'4", on the perimeter at their three, at the point guard and the two wings, versus 5'11", 6'3", 6'4", and 6'2". I mean, it's a difference. That Purdue has triumphed over that twice against Illinois, against positional size. But then that positional size doesn't include a legit center.
Right.
That's not what Illinois has. Also, it doesn't include a first-team All-American point guard. Illinois really doesn't have a point guard. So there are just advantages that UConn has that I think Purdue will have a difficult time overcoming. I don't know how Purdue designs the matchups defensively. Who guards Tristan Newton? Who guards Cam Spencer? If they put Lance Jones on Cam Spencer, that means that that you're asking Braden Smith to guard a 6'5" point guard or a 6'7" wing who's an NBA lottery pick. That becomes a real problem for the Boilers.
Yeah, no, I agree. Connecticut, they're just made differently. And I thought going into the tournament, I thought Connecticut was at a level that nobody could reach. I thought Purdue was at a level that nobody not named Connecticut could reach. And then I thought that the next group of teams, whoever those were going to fight it out to see who ultimately lost to Connecticut and Purdue. And we found out eventually. I think it's cool that we have the two best teams in the country. I don't remember the last time. By the way, I don't think Olajuwon was 7 feet, but he was certainly amazing. Maybe he was 7 feet.
He was.
When was the last time we had the bona fide two best teams in the country meeting for the title?
I'm trying to remember. I know that Illinois-Carolina in 05 is an example of that. I don't know if we've had it since. You could construe it if you wish. No, we had two number ones in 15, but we did not have the best team even in the title game because that was the year that Kentucky was undefeated and lost in the semi. So we didn't have it then. It's really rare. It does not happen often that we get to this stage of the tournament. We may have two teams that have become the best, like in 2012, Kansas in the final against that Kentucky team with Anthony Davis. Certainly Kansas was every bit of a great team and certainly belonged on that floor, but entered the tournament as a number two seed.
Yep.
So we had great teams then, but we didn't have this where one of the things that I try to tell people when I talk about the brackets is that the first thing you want to do is pick the right champion. That's the most important ingredient in winning your bracket.
Okay.
Not always indispensable, but it's really important because you get all the points they accumulate on the way, et cetera. And many people don't understand what makes an NCAA champion. A lot of people pick Houston on their brackets. You could look it up on ESPN or whatever, or Yahoo. A lot of people pick Houston. They have no chance to win this. Even if Jamal Shedd stays healthy, can't win it. They don't meet the criteria. You got to have NBA first-round guy. You got to be top 20 offense defense at KenPom. You got to have a rim protector. You've got to have wings that can slash and hit the lane and create things against defenses that are really well-studied. All of these things. And you have to have a point guard who knows how to play, who's a winner. It helps if he's a pro, but if he's not, he's got to be somebody who is definitely in command of his team. Over the last 25, 30, 40 years, depending on which of those criteria you're talking about, it's almost universal. I mean, you just don't get lucky in this thing. It's too hard. You got to be lucky, but you can't just be lucky. And what we have in these two teams are two that meet the criteria. They have all of that. And that's what makes it so fascinating to me that we got to the end of this and we have two teams that no one's going to say at the end, did they break the mold? They don't have to break the mold. They are the mold.
Right. Mike DeCourcy, before I let you go, I think you described more UConn than Purdue in that, but
yes,
I don't believe that Purdue has no chance here because Zach Edey could go completely off, you know, just nuts. If he catches the ball close enough to the basket, I don't even Donovan Clingan is, I think, at his mercy. If Edey catches the ball close enough to the goal. But let me ask you real quick. You mentioned Kentucky. Your level of surprise that Cal has left to go to Arkansas, and was it really kind of over anyway in Lexington?
Well, I mean, think about it this way. Matt Painter will play for the biggest championship in the sport tonight. The last 3 years, they lost to North Texas, Fairleigh Dickinson, and St. Peter's.
Right.
A 14, a 15, and a 16. So that tells you what's possible if you maintain a steady feel about your program, if you remain rational about your program. And, okay, like, all right, this wasn't what we wanted, losing to St. Peter's. It wasn't what we wanted that Marquise Noel took it over against us in the second round last year and we had no answer. It wasn't what we wanted that we didn't know how to defend a curl against Oakland. But we have the right coach. He's continuing to get good players. We're going to get it right. That was not the prevailing attitude at Kentucky. The attitude at Kentucky is you have to be on that tightrope and you can't fall off. And that's really hard to do in college basketball now, Adam.
Uh-huh.
I mean, look at Carolina last year. Look at Kansas this year. Kansas couldn't put five good players on the floor for half of their games this year. Five good players they couldn't do. It's Kansas.
Right.
They won the whole thing 2 years ago when they had 12 good players. This year they couldn't find five. That's how hard it is now with the transfer portal, with recruiting as it is, with the decline in American basketball talent entering college. With all of that, it's harder than it's ever been. And to believe that you can have a program that never slips off that rope is a fantasy.
Well, you just described the fan base, Kentucky's fan base. Their standards are, like, Cal gave them an Elite Eight and a national championship, like, in the first 3 years, and they thought it was always going to be like that. Always.
Right.
And it's just never always going to be like that. I think Cal was also ready to go.
He was not ready to leave Kentucky.
You don't think
except
so?
Except for the fact, no, I mean, he became ready to go because they were packing his bags for him. But if there had been no bags, if they had taken the Purdue approach, the Purdue fan base approach to their circumstance over the last few years, he would still be there. There's no doubt. But when someone is in your yard, you know, basically saying get out, at a certain point you say, well, if I've got a chance to get out, I'm getting out. And he got the chance.
The call is coming from inside the house, is what Mike DeCourcy is saying. Sporting News at TSN Mike. Hey, thank you very much. I will talk to you very soon.
You bet, Adam. Thank you.
You got it. Mike DeCourcy of the Sporting News is in Phoenix. All right, when we come back, Darren Revell on collectibles, on the value of Caitlin Clark as well. Next.
Going beyond the box scores, Adam Gold on the North Carolina Sports Network.
Are you taking care of someone on Medicare? Navigating Medicare can be overwhelming. You're not alone. The NC Department of Insurance SHIP program can help you figure out what steps to take and when. SHIP counselors can answer your questions. Visit NCSHIIP.com or call toll-free at 855-408-1212. SHIP provides free, unbiased help in all 100 counties.
Project supported by grants from the Administration for Community Living. Contents do not necessarily represent official views of nor an endorsement by ACL, HHS, or the U.S. government.
It's playoff time in the NBA and the NHL. Baseball's in full swing, and FanDuel is your place to bet on every game. Adam Gold here, and right now, new customers can get $200 in bonus bets guaranteed when you make your first $5 wager, because you know me. FanDuel.com, promo code AGS to sign up. FanDuel.com, promo code AGS to sign up. Then you can bet on anything. Slap shots, home runs, slam dunks, all on an app that is safe, secure, and easy to use. $200 in bonus bets await when you place your first $5 wager. Visit FanDuel.com, promo code AGS to get started. FanDuel is America's number one sports book. Must be 21 and older and present in North Carolina. First online real money wager only. $10 deposit required. Bonuses issued as non-withdrawable bonus bets that expire 7 days after receipt. Restrictions apply. See full terms at FanDuel.com/sportsbook. Gambling problem? Call 877-718-5543 or visit morethanagame.nc.gov.
The Body Armor State Games are coming to Charlotte this June. Registration is open to athletes of all ages and skill levels. In 25 different sports. The Body Armor State Games features 13,000 athletes and 700 teams. Don't miss out on North Carolina's largest sports festival of the year. Visit BodyArmorStateGames.org today. The Body Armor State Games are proud to partner with Truist, Harris Teeter, and Blue Cross and Blue Shield of North Carolina.
Trust ACT Construction Equipment and Bandit Wood Chippers and Stump Grinders to position your tree service for success. ACT Construction Equipment is your authorized dealer for sales, service, parts, and rentals for Bandit wood chippers and stump grinders. ACT Construction Equipment has been your authorized dealer for Bandit equipment for over 10 years. Visit one of our six North and South Carolina locations or actce.com for more details on Bandit wood chippers and stump grinders. ACT Construction Equipment, always the right equipment for the job.
Healthcare.gov is here for you when life happens. If you lost your health coverage because of turning 26, going off Medicaid, leaving your job, or moving, you could be eligible to enroll in new coverage now. And if you need to update your coverage because of marriage or having a baby, you could also be eligible. But don't wait. There's a limited time to enroll. Check your eligibility at healthcare.gov today. Life happens. Get covered. Paid for by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services.
It's the first day of the first grade, and she found a new best friend. It's a laid-back Sunday afternoon you wish would never end.
The homemade taste of Bluebell and good friends gathered round. The good old days are being made right now.
St. Louis brought the world gooey butter cake. Now Bluebell brings us gooey butter cake ice cream. A cake batter ice cream with a luscious cream cheese swirl and gooey butter cake pieces. Mmm, it's the gateway to the best in pints and half gallons.
The good old days are being made right now.
The good old days are being made right now.
Look for Bluebell ice cream at your local grocer and pick up your favorite flavor today.
Is Adam Gold.
Anti-vax, anti-sax. Who's going to say no to that on the campaign trail? You can put that on a bumper sticker. You can slap that on the podium when Aaron Rodgers is at the campaign rally. You're not going to be a football player for the Jets and be on the ticket and campaign. You can't do both.
The Adam Gold Show.
Oh, look at that. Look at that.
I know.
Very nice.
I know.
Very nice.
This has been fun.
I know, I'm sure it has. So what are we, about 30 minutes away?
I think
from
so.
Being
yes.
dark? I'm going to need my headlights?
Yeah. Yes.
30 minutes?
Apparently the animals are going to act weird.
Are you, that's right.
Yeah. They're confused.
I did notice that Harriet, the corgi,
yes,
was not interested in eating this morning.
Oh, well, that's interesting.
Which is rare for her because
yeah.
she scarfs food.
Right.
Like her food doesn't even like get to the surface of the bowl.
Yes, exactly.
She eats it like as we're pouring it
out
of the scoop.
That's how Biff is, too. And plus, you know, those corgis, they got to keep the fluffy butts. So, I mean,
that
they,
is
can't,
true.
They can't like get
keep
it
stale. Keep her pants. Her pants all nice.
Yeah.
Earl the Weimaraner, like, you got to convince him.
Oh,
eat. He is not interested.
No.
No, he doesn't eat.
Do you have to make it fancy? Like put stuff on it to entice him?
No, he'll eat it eventually.
Oh, okay.
Like, you know, you don't want to eat, you don't want to eat. Fine.
I just got to keep
Harriet away from it.
Yeah.
So I didn't realize that animals are going to, so she was acting weird. I'm like, you're not eating. That's weird.
That's why.
There you go. Because that happened today.
Yep.
We have the eclipse coming up in less than 30 minutes. There's a lot to do. But I was curious about value of the women's tournament, and I know just who to talk to. It has been a while. Darren Revelle, my friend, sports, business, maven, guru, entrepreneur, Collect Media. You forgot the vowels in Collect, sir. You're such a Gen Zer.
You know, I think it's more about wanting to own the trademark. So, you know,
okay.
I don't know if I could have owned it and needed to own it. So we figured people could get by it. They're calling it something else. That's okay with me as long as they're talking about
it. Yeah, absolutely. All right. So I want to ask you about Caitlin Clark and what her value is, but I want you to tell us first, what is Collect, which is CLLCT. Tell me what this is. I know you have become one of the country's foremost, I guess, experts. Expert might not even be the right word.
You are a collector.
Right.
Yeah, I'm a big collector, and, you know, I spend so much time during every day looking at these things, and I said to my wife, my goal is to feel like I've never worked a day in my life. And in order to do that, I have to constantly change. So in the beginning, sports business. And then I felt like, you know, talking about and doing gambling was something that was good. And now I'm on to what's probably the ultimate, which is just, you know, covering this business. This business since COVID has turned into such a legitimate alt asset.
Right.
That, you know, people, if you're smart, like, I mean, that's a hell of a qualifier,
right?
But if you're smart and you put money in the right places, this is not only fun, but you can make money as well. And, you know, I've done well, and I think it's time for a serious journalist outlet to cover this.
Darren Revelle is joining us here. Collect Media, get rid of the O, get rid of the C, and you've got Collect. So here's my question, because I was a kid, and I was a huge baseball card kid, and I had complete sets. And I didn't buy the complete sets. You only compiled the complete sets by buying packs of cards.
Right, which is so fun.
Right.
You knew the guy. You're like, if I got one more Urbano Lugo, the Angels pitcher in the 1987 Wood Border Top set, I was going to. Yeah, how many? You know, you had those guys that you keep getting over and over again.
I had Phil Garner. I would get like a Phil Garner in every pack when he was with the. He was either with the A's or with the Astros at the time.
Either way, he had a hell of a mustache.
Oh, it was a tremendous mustache. So yeah. All those baseball cards that I got older, and I said, "Yeah, I told my cousin he could have them." That was a bad idea.
Yeah, I don't know about that. I mean, how old are you?
I'm older than you, Darren. I'm 50. How old am I? 57.
Yeah. So you're actually in an area where it gets a little bit tough. For me, I was in the junk wax era of 86, 87, 88,
okay.
89, where basically, you know, we're going to have an article on our site this week on should you grade it? And people think, oh, I got a Roger Clemens 1985 Tops. Well, guess what? In a PSA 9, goes from 1 to 10, in a PSA 9, a Roger Clemens 85 Tops, if it's among the best of the best condition-wise, is $34 today.
That's pretty good.
So you don't want to pay $30 to grade it,
like
shipping and handling.
Oh, I see.
So if you're talking, you know, if you're talking 75, even 75 and, you know, Yount and Carter and that set, I mean – you know, there's a lot of it. What people don't realize is the first like six grades, they're very close together in terms of price. So let's just do, because I know this off the top of my head, 1986 Fleer Michael Jordan.
Right.
Okay. A one is about $1,800 if you have it in a one.
Which okay.
Means like there's rounded corners,
okay.
Surface problems. Okay. A two is about $2,300. Three is about $2,700. Four is about $3,300. Now, see how closely bunched together this is? Five is maybe $3,600. Six is $4,200. Seven is $5,800. Eight is $7,000. Nine is $17,000. And a 10, and there's 324 of them, at least graded by PSA, a 10 is $180,000.
Wow. That's big.
So it's so bunched, you know, so people go, oh my God, I have a 1986 Fleer Jordan. And okay, congratulations. You probably have between a 3 and a 5, which is going to get you somewhere in between $2,800 and
$4,500. It's not bad. It's not bad for a card.
Out of a shoebox. Okay. And then you also then got to grade it, right? Because you got to prove that.
Sure.
It's bad. And there's some, you know, there's some friction, and then you got to sell it, and then there's some eBay fees. So you come away with, you know, like a grand, and that gets disappointing to people because they, you know, obviously when they find that they have this card, they automatically think, well, I got this card. This is amazing.
Right.
And, you know, so that's what we're trying to, I want to educate people.
All right. And by the way, if you want to find out, you know, through Darren's own words,
yeah,
what this is about, I saw you put out a video explaining what Collect is. So go to Darren, yeah, Revelle on Twitter. I refuse to call it X. It's Twitter. If I can type
it's
in Twitter.com, then it's still Twitter. Don't
correct,
lie to me. All right. Caitlin Clark is America's fascination right now. I saw where Dawn Staley thanked her for elevating women's basketball and making it to what people are just watching it, you know, it's setting records every time she's on one of her games is on. It'll be interesting to see what the championship number is. We'll get that later today.
What happens now? That's the real.
That is. But what is Caitlin Clark's value? So if somebody's got Caitlin Clark autographing a poster, like what is the worth of that? She probably signed so much.
Yeah, the real value is so we've been able to confirm that she only wore 6 jerseys all season. She only wore one of the same black jersey. So barely, you know, and she wore 2 white jerseys that she set both records in.
Right.
It's going to be interesting. That's where the value is, and someone's already offered, we're told, $500,000 for one of the jerseys. What's going to happen there? I think, you know, she's done a good job of collecting these herself, and whether she thinks they're her personal or family mementos or whether she wants to sell them, that's going to be interesting. I did think it was interesting that she keeps throwing the ball to her brother at the end of the game.
Yes, she does. I think they had to get one back. Did they not have to get it back after the national semifinal?
I think they did. Yep.
Like, I saw that. I saw she tossed the ball into the stands, and then all of a sudden, like, she and other people were, like, running after the ball. Like, we had to go get that ball back. What's the big deal?
Yeah. So it seems like there's something with her collecting, you know, a certain, you know, if she's collecting it or if she's going to sell it, that's going to be an interesting thing. But we know we have a card that sold for $75,000, which is the second highest card with a woman on it. Serena Williams being number one, which sold for over $200,000.
Awesome.
So we'll see what else. I mean, I think, you know, what happens now is really the interesting thing, because the WNBA has not been able, despite having stars,
right,
who we've said were going to be crossover, did not cross over. And, you know, so it's going to be interesting to see what happens there.
I agree. Well, we get these stars, and sometimes the stars bring you to the sport to watch them, and then you discover other stars. I'm sure that happened in many ways for golf. Like, I think the golf viewing numbers are higher than, higher now without Tiger than they were before Tiger. If you follow my drift.
Yes,
right?
Yes.
So we have come here to watch him and found others. So hopefully for people who are really interested in it, they will go to watch Caitlin. Some people who are not otherwise interested in it would go to watch Caitlin and go, oh, wait a second. This Juju Watkins character is amazing. I got to watch her more, or I got to watch Paige Beckers more, or any of the incredible players that we have seen throughout this tournament.
And also, it's the window at – you know, I think, you know, that although NIL has done some things to hold some people in the game, you just, you know, you got 3 years, even if it's Haley Van Lith who's going to move and move and move.
Right.
You know her, you know, and you don't know the guys, you know, because they're going to be the best are going to be one and done.
That is true. So let me drill down there for a second here before we have to let Darren Revelle go. So NIL, transfer portal, all of that, is it almost working counterintuitive to athletes sticking around? If athletes stick around for a year or two in college, we see this in the women's game. We're not seeing it as often in the men's game, but maybe we'll see it more. And it builds their brand, their recognition, their public, you know, the all of that allows people to become more familiar with them. Does the portal and NIL do any damage to it?
I mean, I think the thing is, how are these people going to be paid in the future? Are they going to get directly paid? Because this whole thing is just, you know, a charade. This is not what it was intended for. The NCAA can't control it.
Right.
And it's professional anyway. It's just a different level of profession. Yeah. You know,
right.
It's just wild.
We could go to actual name, image, and likeness.
Yes.
As well as the universities paying the students. Right.
And those people never going to classes and that name just being on the jersey.
And that's possible. I mean, I'm not sure it would be enormously different than it is today. If they don't want to, I mean, if the best players, if they didn't really want to go to school, they would figure out a way to make it so. So,
yes.
I mean, the value of the athlete. All right, we have to talk about this as often as you will answer the phone call. Darren Revelle, Collect Media, no vowels, you don't, vowels and media, for sure, but for Collect, no vowels. And I appreciate you, sir. Good luck with the venture. I know it just dropped.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Just don't say, like my friend said, I'm crashing when my website just went up. I'm like, you can't use the word crash to go to sleep.
Got it.
I just got very scared. Yes.
Gotcha.
So thank you, Adam. It's always a pleasure going on with you.
Yeah, it's a brand new thing. Good for Darren Revelle. So he's got a ton of followers. Not all like friendly followers, but
no,
he has a ton of followers. Darren is a lightning rod for people, but it's okay. I went out of my way to annoy people over the weekend.
Yeah, well,
I did.
It happens.
I did. I went out of my way. I kind of poked the hornet's nest intentionally because I was tired of hearing or reading. Like, come on, Carolina fans, you guys lost to state.
Yeah, there was a lot of Carolina hate.
Somebody else had beaten you, then okay, I can see it.
Yeah.
But you got to Sunday, or rather Saturday night at the ACC tournament. Might as well win the game, but it's all right. We had a, state had a great run. The regular season should have been better, but it wasn't. And their end in the Final Four for the first time in 41 years, I had just so much admiration for how much fun they had with it. Because you have to be able to embrace that. Because it is fleeting, right? State has not returned to the land of the blue blood suddenly. So you don't know when you're ever going to have it again. And my alma mater was the same way. Maryland hasn't been back to a Final Four since they won it in 2002. It went consecutive years. It's the only two times the Terrapins have ever been there. You just don't know when it's going to happen. You don't. So for NC State, everybody that we saw, and I saw a ton of fans, was simply having a great time. Even like when we left for the airport at like 10 o'clock, or whatever time we left for the airport, it was earlier than that. We ran into a family who had gone straight from Dallas to Phoenix. They had a blast. They embraced the entire thing. Awesome. And the women, man, I wish we could have been in Cleveland with you, and I know it didn't end where you wanted it to end, but again, you ran into the biggest buzzsaw that there is in college basketball, men or women. They were awesome. Congratulations to South Carolina and Dawn Staley. And we'll congratulate whoever wins tonight between Purdue and UConn. I think it will be UConn. I think UConn's the best team.
And I think it's getting darker.
Oh, is it? I got to go put my headlights on. Victoria, thank you.
Raleigh to Boone, Charlotte to Chapel Hill. Your Carolina is covered. Adam Gold on the North Carolina Sports Network.
Adam Gold from my man, Coach Pete DeRuiter, Capital Financial Advisory Group in Apex. A lot of you know I was out at the Final Four, and I was coming back, and I'm at the airport, and I am at baggage claim, and there he is, Coach Pete DeRuiter, dressed up like one of the guards at Buckingham Palace because he's going to guard your retirement money. Here's the thing. For all the goofiness, he's great at it. You want to plan for your retirement? Don't go anywhere other than Capital Financial Advisory Group and text Adam to 600-700 right now, and we're going to get you one of Coach Pete's best-selling books on retirement planning. He's got a bunch of those. And a total customized retirement plan specially designed for your needs, your wants, your desires to get you to total financial independence in retirement so you can do whatever it is you want. So maybe you want to go see Coach Pete at Buckingham Palace. I don't know. Coach Pete DeRuiter, Capital Financial Advisory Group in Apex. Text Adam to 600-700 today.
It's bow time. Something new just dropped at Bojangles. Take the bold taste of a crispy golden chicken supreme that's been seasoned to perfection, then add dill pickles, Carolina Gold barbecue sauce, and a toasted bun that's great on the go. What do you get? You get a Bo's Bird Dog. In fact, you can grab two of them for $5. So when you're on the go, headed to practice, or need a snack, grab a Bo's Bird Dog. Hurry in before they're gone, available for a limited time. It's Bo time.
There's no time like bow time, but sometimes it's go time. No time to stop. Introducing Bojangles' new Bird Dog, a seasoned to perfection Bojangles Chicken Supreme, dill pickles, Carolina Gold barbecue sauce, all on a toasted bun. Great on the go. Try two Bird Dogs for just $5 or a two Bird Dog combo for just $8. Hurry, Bo's Bird Dogs are available for a limited time only. When you're hungry for flavor and value, it's Bo time.
The future of medicine is here at QC Kinetics. QC is the nation's leader in the most exciting revolution.